Nothing.
If anyone has anything to add to the list, feel free to chat about it, jot it down, or say something, or just in the chat if you want to hear something. You can always call up and have a question as well.
Underage sex.
Have a good question.
Not a good question.
Yeah, that's not a good question.
Mass Effect 3.
It's not even a question.
Kurt Schilling loses all. Dead or Alive 5. Boobs.
Yes.
Steam sales.
Yes.
Jessica. I can never pronounce her name right.
Negri.
Twatch. All right. And then Real Life Stuff.
Mm-hmm. Wait, did you say Twatch?
I thought you said Twatch. We need to have like an intro, like the Junkyard Breakdown, where he like slowly reads all the points. We have time for the Junkyard Breakdown.
There definitely needs to be an intro like that.
Yeah, seriously. I'll even accept dubstep.
I don't know if I'm willing to accept that. We're starting pretty good. We don't need to stoop that low.
I do. I stoop so low.
Oh, damn.
Hello. Who the hell said rape time with diction? Where'd that come from?
It's the worst time with diction. Yeah. It's not a good time.
The only time you want to have with me is brunch time, because brunch is amazing.
Brunch is very good. Well, welcome to ChronoCast.
What's your favorite brunch food?
Damn it, Chuck.
I've never actually had like a real... I'll do like the mimosa and eggs and like, you know, bacon and stuff. Maybe like a
bacon. Do you have crispy bacon?
Alright, give it to Chilled.
Are we good, Chuck?
Yeah, I'm sorry. I apologize.
No, Jack, it's okay. My feelings have been hurt.
You has no feels.
I know. That's what sometimes they tell me in the comment section. Well, welcome to ChronoCast. We are on episode 8, I believe. And we
Is it really?
I quit. We have with us Eutoric, LD Shadow Lady, Eat My Addiction, Junkyard, Jan the Canadian, and Rager, who is formerly imposing himself as Jesus, and I'm Chill Chaos. We're the show where we talk about things and hopefully girls with boobs come on. So that is
boobs!
Thank you, Junkyard. He is a great man. Junkyard, you've had boobs for how long?
Yeah. 23 years. They're in the room too, by the way, right now.
Oh,
hi,
wow.
Honey. Oh, they said they've been longer than 23 years? You mean, they're not down to your kneecaps.
Oh, my God.
Yeah. Oh, wow.
What if she said, just go fuck yourself?
Yeah, yeah, pretty much she just did. Yeah. She said that. Now, we've been, how long did we date before we got married? 2.5 years. So I've been with you for over 25 years.
Does it feel like it's been 25 years?
Quarter of a century boobs right now.
I know. Quarter of a century boobs.
John, when does the life get sucked out? How old do you have to be when like you just start not feeling anything anymore?
When we're all done and I'm just done with the... I don't know. I still feel the love for her every single day.
Is this a lie? Are you just
You're just saying that because she's in the room.
She's coming over now. Oh, my God.
Because I feel...
I always thought it was
real
like...
Real quick,
it...
why don't you ask her and then she could leave? There you go.
I'm not leaving.
No.
Do you,
Mrs. Junkyard, when did your love for your husband die? Did it at all? I'm sorry, I phrased that wrong.
Okay, there you go.
When he asks.
You're so funny.
Junk, it's right. Okay, Junk. There's always Jessica in the Gree.
Yeah.
Always Jessica in the Gree.
She's soft. We've determined this.
Well, that was just some random guy at a Comic-Con who touched her.
Yeah, but she's most likely
her?
Soft.
She tweeted it too, though, remember?
She was very soft. Oh. I'm going to meet her one day.
I bet she exfoliates.
I don't think she exfoliates.
I bet she does. That's how you make yourself soft.
But it seems like that'd be too much work.
No, it's easy. It is really easy.
You guys have exfoliated before?
I exfoliate all the time. The word exfoliate is starting to sound really weird to
me
right
now.
What
exactly is exfoliating? Maybe for
that's
the
just
the
like clearing out the pores, isn't it?
Yeah. Yeah.
It's like taking off the dry
skin. Oh, I thought it was something different.
You use like an exfoliating scrub. Oops.
Oh, I thought it was like air getting blown into you, something like that.
No, are you?
I think you're talking of like colonic irrigation or something.
What?
I have no idea what you're talking about.
You're probably thinking of an enema or something.
No, I know what that is. Chuck, isn't that when, like, aren't you old enough where you need that now? Or no, that's something else.
No, that's a colostomy.
Everybody needs them.
You're thinking a colostomy, what?
Colonoscopy.
Colonoscopy.
Yeah, colonoscopy, where they stick the tube up there. Yeah, in fact, I thought I was at the point where I needed to go, and I was like, so I went for my physical, and I was going, oh my God, I don't want to go through this. And I thought for sure I was going to walk in, and he was going to go, bend over, please. But fortunately, he said, and I said, do I need this yet? And he goes, nah, you don't need it till you're 50. And I went, sweet.
Yeah, but like,
I got a couple years.
Yeah, you're going to be doomed in 3 years. Ouch. Well,
I don't know.
But you're looking forward to that.
You know they have coffee enemas?
Coffee?
You should get a coffee enema. It gives you gives you the caffeine right away. That's like the point of it.
Yeah, but don't you feel like a you're not even shitting? That's good.
I'm not even shitting you.
But there's like a lot of setup involved, I would think, with the situation.
Yeah, well, yeah, you gotta set up an appointment, you know, you gotta go down there, you gotta I just saw a Jackass video.
I saw someone like put beer up their ass immediately.
Steve-O.
Yeah, that looked very not fun. Yutori,
but it was funny.
Doing?
Yeah, did some like real bodily damage to himself.
Yeah, then he stopped and he turned into a normal person, kind of.
Yeah, well, they said, he's like hurt his, some of his brain cells.
Some?
Killed those things.
God.
Well, he was a drug addict and then he finally got clean and stuff, and he has been for quite a while now.
You had to be a drug addict to do some of the stunts he was doing. Literally, he shoved beer.
Well, yeah,
up his
he
ass.
Was. He admitted it.
Yeah, he had it.
He was on drugs.
Well, that whole thing was interesting.
There you go.
I love Jackass.
That's it.
But getting away from coffee enemas and weird shit and being old, what young people do, or at least that's what they tell us to do, we play video games. Dixon, how long have you been playing video games for?
My whole life, chilled.
The whole life. Everyone else, the whole life?
My very first video game was Pong.
My God.
Actually, that was my first video game, too.
I played it, and I went down with a pocket full of dimes to Newberry Pharmacy, and I used to buy myself a whole bunch of the Wacky Pack stickers.
Wacky Pack stickers?
Wacky Pack. It was, you open up, and there was always stickers in there of Wacky Packs, and just a variety of different type of stickers like that. And then I would sit there and put, like, 20 pieces of gum in my mouth and play Pong, you know, until I ran out of dimes. And that's all I did. It was my brother and I, we went down there and played Pong. And that was my very first game. I still remember it. That
sounds like, you know, inspirational.
Can you remember
the first game that you owned?
Yeah, it was Atari 2600.
Uh-huh.
And it was, Wacky Pack. There you go. That's what they were, Wacky Pack. And my first game that I was addicted to was Pitfall.
Pitfall?
Pitfall.
How can you be addicted to Pitfall? There's no addiction with that game. It's literally you just jump over pits and try not to fall.
Dude, that was high-tech video games back then. Hello? Hello? I'm still intrigued with Minecraft, so we're good.
Oh, it hasn't come far. It's literally
Simple things intrigue me.
There were no circles in Pitfall. There were no circles in Minecraft. It's pretty much the same thing. I don't know why not just the wheels.
You know, you guys remember that Pitfall game? They like remade it for the PlayStation and had Bruce Campbell as the voice actor.
Why does that sound really familiar?
It was. I think they just called it like Pitfall 3D. It was a pretty bad game because it was just like unfair. But Bruce Campbell, like, where's Rager? Where is Rager? I'm not talking about Bruce Campbell here.
Yeah, he loves him.
I haven't even heard from him. He's
got a hard on for him.
What the hell is Rager?
I don't feel better now.
Dude, don't you feel good?
I mixed marshmallows with beer.
I told you that wasn't a good idea, and he did it anyway.
That's gonna inflate your stomach, dude.
Yeah. He kept on doing two at a time because he likes to take two at a time.
That's how people die.
I see what you did there, Jan.
Thank you.
Bruce Campbell.
That's how people die.
Yeah, that's how people die. You can't do that. You're not supposed to do that.
Oh, okay, good.
No, but
I ate a whole bag of marshmallows.
You ate the entire thing.
Stop being a girl. It's a bag of marshmallows.
All right, so what is this video of?
This is Pitfall 3D. So this junk, this is your childhood, but changed.
No, that's not Now find a video of Atari 2600 Pitfall.
Yeah, but
you know what that looks like. It's all bleep loops, okay?
Yeah, this is
new age. Look at how it's like. It's barely 3D. It's pretty much just a side scroller.
This doesn't look bad for PlayStation 1.
I mean,
it doesn't at all.
All right, now it's find
just look at that depth of field, though. It's like you're going to die trying to do most of these platform jumps.
It was $26.99. My bad.
So, yeah, Atari 2600. See if that comes
There
out.
You go. This is... Junk, this is old people stuff.
I know. Yeah.
No one wants to see
that's
loops,
it. That's it.
Okay?
That's it.
Yeah.
Junk, what it's is dumb. This?
So that's dated. God, that's bad graphics ball. Equals bad game. We all know
that's
this.
That's what I used the to gameplay play. The gameplay looks horrible. Kid.
Oh, it's Activision 2? Come on, they're going to charge me DLC for extra logs. I don't want this. This is stupid.
Yeah, it was Activision.
Great. Yeah. I don't know, Jack. Your childhood was maybe filled with some bad times.
Look at that. That was classic days.
Nah, as long as the gameplay was good. But I don't even. He's. I don't get this. He should be dead.
It was good. And then. But then. And as. Remember when you. Connected it to the TV, you had to connect it into the antenna, and then there was a switch on the back that you had to switch back and forth from the antenna to the Xbox to the Atari 2600, and I would always forget to switch it back, and my dad would start screaming, "What the hell's going on with this damn TV? Why ain't it working?" It's like, "Oh, sorry, Dad, I forgot to flip it back." And he goes, "Take that damn thing off the damn TV. You're ruining the goddamn reception. Just sit there and hold the damn antenna and don't move, kid." It's like, so I had to sit there and hold the antenna for an hour.
Your dad was a very angry person.
Yeah. Mm. Okay, I exaggerated a little bit.
Yeah, when me and my sisters would play N64, because we had like one TV that we could play on, yeah, my dad would get all confused too, like why the TV isn't working.
So you can relate, exactly.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Except for didn't have an antenna. So.
See, there was no like getting upset in our house. It was just they bring out the belt when the TV didn't work. That's what happened with my grandfather and the Sega Genesis. Not a good time.
Bring out the belt.
Bring out the belt.
The genocide.
It was more of a threat than anything else, but when you know, when your grandfather got the belt, you're like, oh shit. You know, it was good times, man. It was good times.
Now did you guys always have TVs with remote controls?
No, always. Not my grandfather's house. It had a dial. Like a
what? A dial?
A dial. You had to turn the dial on it.
Holy shit.
Oh, this is old.
That was my TV. I had a TV like that, and it sucked because my brother and I, we would share our room. And so 10 o'clock, we would always notoriously turn off the TV. That's when we turn off the TV to go to sleep, to go to get ready for school in the morning. And it was we always got in fights. Get up and go turn off the TV. No, it's your turn. You turn off the TV. And it's like, I don't want to get up and turn off the TV. I'm comfortable. You go, shut up and turn off the TV or I'll kick your ass. Because my brother was like a foot bigger than me. I was like, okay, fine. And so I go turn off the TV.
Tell you, it was only 13 different channels you could do because the dialer would only go 13 times.
Yep, you're right.
Good stuff.
So I remember.
Grandpa, where's HBO?
We don't get that, son.
They didn't have that.
Channel 14. Good luck.
But I remember when we got our first TV with a remote control, and my brother pissed me off about something, and so I hid it from him, and then I forgot where I hid it.
Oh, you're not gonna live.
Oh, yeah, no, it's for 2 weeks, we couldn't find it, and I didn't know where it was, and I said, I don't know, and I didn't realize it was me that actually lost it, because I totally forgot, you know, I hit it, then I went and started watching TV and totally forgot, and it's like, who turned off the TV, and I was like, I don't know.
This is why you got to remember your own lies, Junk. If you start forgetting your own lies, it gets really complicated.
So, but then I found it 2 weeks later, and I was so happy, and I just conveniently put it on the coffee table and walked away.
So it just magically appeared on the coffee table.
Now, have you had this conversation with your parents about actually confessing bad things you did as a kid?
What do you mean bad things?
Well, just things that you've done that you feel a little bit of guilty about, so you want to share it with your parents. But it's at the point now where your parents will find it somewhat comical and they'll laugh about it.
No, you tell the priest. You just tell the priest and hopefully he forgives you and then everything's okay.
Wait, what are we talking about?
Bad things? No, wait.
No, like, say if you've done something as a kid, like that was bad, like you were afraid to tell your parents then, and like 5-6 years later you tell them now, like, oh, you trickster, you.
See, my parents still don't like the fact that I drink booze on occasion. I'm fucking 27 years old.
See, because you guys are still pretty. I mean, how many of you? Who's in their 20s right here? We got.
Me.
I guess.
I think pretty much everyone except for Lizzie and Jen.
And me, yeah.
The men.
I turned 19. Well,
my parents are the same way, Dixon. They're like, you're still drinking beer? What did you. You're not old enough to do that. I'm like 25 and I can do whatever the fuck I want.
Yeah, my dad still says like you shouldn't be allowed to drink alcohol neat. Like
alcohol neat?
Yeah.
Now Rager,
like, you straight.
Oh.
Straight.
Oh yeah.
Oh, mead, okay.
No, I thought meat. Yeah, I thought he meant like wringing out a steak, like an uncooked steak and drinking the juice.
Mead
is like just neat.
Mead.
I've had mead.
Like tidy.
I'm not saying mead. I'm not saying mead.
What are you
saying?
But mead. I like mead. No, let's talk mead. That's my last
okay,
name.
Okay, let's talk about mead.
It's pretty damn good, but it's a, you know, it's a dessert wine, so you don't want to have
it's
it
a sweet
too often.
Sweet wine, yeah.
Yeah, it's really sweet.
A sweet wine.
Yeah.
Aw, so is it like give you like compliments as you drink it? You're so good looking. Oh, it's such a sweet wine.
It's really good. You can warm it up with spices and stuff, and it tastes really good. It's kind of like a, like if you took apple cider and warmed it up and gave it some zest. It's pretty good. I like it.
Apple cider is really good.
It's very good. You want to like eat some creme brulee and follow it up with some mead. That would be just the,
See, we just say cider. We don't say apple cider.
Well,
cider is like the apple
cider.
One, and then there's the other flavors of cider. So like
there's loads of kinds of cider. There's pear cider.
Yeah, but like when you say cider, you don't say apple cider because cider is just made with apples.
No,
but it's also made with pears.
I know that, but
there's also blueberry cider. There's I can't think of other cider. That one.
Is there strawberry cider?
Probably. There's gotta be.
I like strawberries.
Yeah, there is a strawberry cider.
There's gotta be.
I'm not a big fan of apple cider because it's like weird.
It's bitter. It's good. It's American.
I don't like apples. I have a strong dislike for apples.
What
the
hell is wrong with
you?
What is wrong with you?
How could you not like apples?
Okay.
What about apple pie?
I don't like apple pie and like apple
like
crisp.
Apple
you know how the apples get like really weird and mushy? I feel like it has like a really gross texture to it and it's kind of like gross.
It's amazing with like.
No, I
like
used to not like to... apple pies for that reason because I always thought it was.
But it's a little weird, isn't it?
You get apple pie with a big old scoop of vanilla ice cream. Oh,
well,
yeah.
See, that's good. I agree with that. Like I'll eat like the crust, like if it's nice and like you know like flaky and like sweet.
So you want a flake.
You want a flaky crust?
Flaky crust.
Are you flaky or
something? Wow. Really?
Oh, God. All right, let's get off food and back on the gaming, because it's literally, I'm really hungry. And
I can't believe she doesn't like pie. What's the matter with you, Jan?
I know. I don't hate pie. I never said I hate pie. I just don't like the way that the apples are textured, like when they're half cooked.
I updated
like
my
that.
Picture for you.
Wow, fuck you.
It's pointing, for
you
me,
know,
it's
should be the other way
nothing,
around.
I updated my picture, too. It's sexy.
It's kind of...
Have you ever had to clean a room and you found a half-eaten apple pie there? Is that one reason, too?
No. But a lot of people waste so much food. Like, there's, like... I had to throw out, like, a whole pizza the other day because it was, like, a whole... like full medium pizza, not even touched, but I had to throw it away.
Were
and like there was Chinese food that people had and they barely ate any of it. And there was like six big containers of like Chinese food. It's amazing how much people like, you know, just waste stuff. It's kind of sad.
I'm hungry. Stop. I'm hungry.
All right. Chilled. Start it off.
Okay. Well, what do you mean start it off? We've been going for half an hour.
I don't get how can we talk about the Mass Effect 3 anyway without ruining it?
Well, no, just in general that they're actually going to come through with the release DLC that QQers and whiners won the day and that, you know.
Apparently though, it's not going to make it any better. That's what I've heard.
Well, I heard it's a big file though, so it's something. Something big.
And this is a big fuck you sign, really high resolution. That's all it is.
HD, you suck.
But no, I mean
that is all.
What do you guys think? I mean, I know it's supposed to be as much as a fan's game as it is the creator's game, but do you think if fans don't like it, the creator should go back and change it? I mean, what do you
think? I think so, because I didn't finish the game because I heard so much bad stuff about the ending, so I kind of waited. And then I heard about them doing an extended edition ending, so I'm like, okay, I'm just going to wait till they do that and start playing it again. So that's what I'm going to do. So then it comes out tomorrow, I heard, so I'm going to go play it tomorrow.
But is that fair? Is that justified that, you know, you're not going to play the game just because people said that the ending was bad?
That's what I did.
I want to play the game. I want to finish it. I just haven't got around to it because, like, I have no, like, urgency to play it just because of that reason.
That's true.
Because of the end.
Exactly. I'm, like, probably a third of the way through that game, and I just kind of stopped playing it 3 months ago.
Well, then we should blame everyone that said the ending was bad. Let's just blame all of them.
I mean, I like the multiplayer is really cool, and I think that's something I'd like to see them build on that even more. Like, I don't know. I it was kind of like... Everyone was poo-pooing on the ending, so I was like, I don't even want to see the ending now. Even if I like it, like, I don't want to see it, because you guys are fucking babies.
Well, I think that's one thing, too. You have it, like, where now peer pressure almost like, well, crap, now I gotta hate the ending, because everyone else hates it. And I keep spilling soda. Oh, fuck.
Dude, what's wrong with you? Here's your problem. You're drinking soda. Drink water, man.
Yeah, grab a beer, dude.
Isn't it the point where... Okay, the philosophy of games themselves, how many... multiplayer games are getting developed compared to single player games or story based games like Mass Effect. I mean, isn't it at the point where all these great story based games are going away, so they're just saying screw it, let's just make an ending and concentrate on the multiplayer?
I think the studio BioWare, they stated that they were rushed towards the end there to get the game out, and so the ending was not what they wanted. So that's why they're doing this whole, like, okay, mulligan, we're going to give you a real ending now.
But, I mean, then, it took them a while then to even admit that then. Because the first thing that they kind
of
did
was 2 months of people, like, chastising them, and they weren't... Maybe it might have been, like, you know, honestly, it might have been a legal thing. Like, they weren't allowed to say why. Because it's, like, no studio... Like, who was the publisher? EA? Like, EA would never let anyone say bad things about them until they ran through a bunch of red tape, you know? So, like, saying, like, the publisher rushed us to completion, therefore the ending was not up to par with our standards, like, that's a bad thing, and EA doesn't like that.
Well, I don't think you could ever say that about anything. But the problem, I think, what lies in with a lot of publishers are doing, aren't they kind of forcing the hand of many developers to release a game, even if it's kind of, you know, half-finished? I mean, you look at Star Wars Yellow Republic, and that game was 3 years in development, and I still didn't think it was finished.
Maybe. I mean, that's an MMO. The MMOs are tricky.
Well, then,
you know,
they're never quite.
All right, well, then, what about a concept of a game where the game with a never ending, the never ending game, like the never ending song?
No,
like what's that? What's that one game?
This song may never end.
Oh my god, no! Planetside. Back to video games, Junk. Planetside.
Well, what about that concept?
A never ending MMO shooter where you were constantly battling over these three continents on this planet. And they're making a sequel to it right now. Why are you putting up EA stats?
Well, look at for example.
Oh my god, Jill, you're getting too into it now.
No, I'm just look from the beginning of the year. Look at it, how it literally, from the last 6 months, it took a nosedive. It's lost half its value as a company.
That's a company or that's a game?
That's EA. That's EA EA stock. And you know, it peaked back in, you know, November-ish, and then it's just been on a downhill slide ever since Star Wars The Old Republic came out. So
that's hilarious. When Battlefield 3 came out, it was peaking, and then after that...
So is this a, you know, for games having a bad ending, or just games in general being rushed, is this a sign of EA's doing? I mean, most of those games are published by EA when it comes to it, and look at EA's finances. They're just...
You have the Activision one?
The Activision one? How are they doing? I'll get you that in a second.
I want to see a Call of Duty one right now.
Well, Activision has Blizzard under it. The only one that isn't really taking a huge hit, per se, is, I think, Activision. Take-Two is taking a shit as well. Because Activision was the only one that was following the current trends.
Plus, people need to stop being hipsters and buying Call of Duty.
Look, Activision has a cash cows. World of Warcraft isn't dying for a while. You do have the Call of Duty series. It's a cash cow, so they've been pretty good. But when you look at Take-Two...
Fucking hipsters.
Take-Two has gone down the pooper.
They did L.A. Noire, right? That was their last big game.
I don't know, but look at them from whichamacallit. From even the beginning of this year, they just they're kind of back in the bottom of it. We'll see. We'll see what happens.
There's Fousey Otterballs. Fucking laying down the facts about big business over here.
We're getting the facts.
Look at him. He's got his.
Yeah, that's copy and paste type shit.
Taking those because they've been so.
You know, he can ban you from the site and on instant, right? I'm just saying.
He's got super serious MLG copyright skills, I must say.
Well, no, that's the truth about EA. When you have people bet on games and they don't provide, and when investors are going to bet on games, you have a problem if they're not providing the kind of, you know, sustainable cash flow that you want. And he's an investment banker in the tech sector.
Yeah, same. He was. Now he works a job that isn't soul crushing,
where he's allowed to be creative and have a spirit.
Where he's allowed to play League of Legends all day.
I'll play League of Legends. But I mean, Rager, you stopped playing Star Wars, right?
Yeah, once you got to level 50, you got kind of old, so that's why I backed out of it.
I couldn't even make it to level 15. A lot of people feel the same thing.
Well, it was a long grind to do that. It took like lots and lots of hours to do it, but I eventually got there, and I recorded like the last couple of missions of it, and it was all right, but. It wasn't too like groundbreaking like they said it was gonna be, you know.
We'll see. EA still has good franchises.
I would love to get into an MMO, but I never I don't know. I feel like I'd ever have like a crew because I can't do it. I don't like doing that shit alone.
You ever,
Guild Wars 2.
You ever played
Guild Wars 2.
World of Warcraft.
Guild Wars. I did play the beta. That was my first actual MMO like beta that I played. I liked
play
it.
Well.
It wasn't like the most exceptional thing in the world, but it looked like something I can get into. Also, the secret world looks cool just because it has a kind of a H.P. Lovecraft mythos behind it, which is nice.
I played as Keanu Reeves, and he was very sad. That was my character. Sad Keanu Reeves. He had an unemployed actor's scarf thingy. It was good stuff. So, Mass Effect 3 ending. Now that every company's taking a nosedive, you know, well, I guess developers are going to change their endings to suit the needs of their players. I mean, do you think they're going to end up making more Mass Effect?
No.
No?
I mean...
I have no idea. I haven't seen the film. Film?
They might like...
Wow. You just close your goddamn mouth.
No, they're making a film, though, aren't they?
Yeah, they are making a film of it.
I hope that is not a fucking letdown.
They said it's going to be based off the first movie, though. That's it.
I'm still waiting for my Halo film.
It's never I'm thinking
if they
do
gonna make a Halo film?
No. Too late now.
They should. That shit would be...
Yeah, do
well,
that back.
Boring. It would be so boring. The protagonist never talks.
No, he would talk.
You can't see his face.
On the occasion.
Who? You're talking about Master Chief?
Mr. John 117.
I have like a huge beef against video game movies because the entire purpose of a game is for you to play it. It's the user experience. If it's a movie, you take that away and then it always becomes trash because without that, you have to fill it with all this exposition, you know, and dialogue.
I don't know. Resident Evil movies, they're good.
No.
What have you been watching?
Get the fuck out of here.
They're all bad. They've all been bad.
They're bad. Yeah, okay. They're not great films, but, like, they're just good to, like, watch if you're bored. Like, I'll watch a Resident Evil film, like, if I'm, like, with a group of friends and doing stuff, I guess.
The only video game movie that's actually been worth a damn is Japanese, and it's Phoenix Wright. Takashi Miike, the guy that did Ichi the Killer and 13 Assassins, made a Phoenix Wright movie, and apparently it's like spot on the greatest adaptation. Yeah, no, he yells objection. You got the hair, the special effects, you know, the whole like court, every court scene is like a spectator event and shit. Like, they did everything perfect.
What about Dead or Alive and Mortal Kombat? You know, those were pretty good.
What about Max Payne?
Max Payne was terrible.
Yeah.
I never saw it.
Even Mark and Mark couldn't save that.
The only one that I thought was like came close was Silent Hill, but they kind of screwed up the mythos of the, you know, Silent Hill world or whatever, and it kind of ruined it for me.
Goddamn.
Oh yeah, I remember everything.
No, but I think back on the Halo 3 thing, I think the ship has sailed. Almost on Halo in general, like. I don't feel like they're drumming up as much support as Halo 3 was getting in terms of marketing, in terms of advertising it, in terms of literally just putting it so every single like Pepsi or vending machine had Halo 2, Halo 3, Mountain Dew everywhere. I just don't see that anymore. I kind of feel like Halo's like the yesteryears.
No.
Because it is.
Yeah, but that's
it's just a big cash cow now, basically.
Stop being nostalgic. Just move on to the next thing.
Why do I have to move on to the next thing? I tried to with Star Wars, and it bit me in the ass, so I went back to WoW.
I just want to point out, my wife brought me down a plate of food. I just want to put that out.
You know what? Fuck you, Junk.
I just want to point that out because she's in the room right now, and if you don't give her credit,
she went back upstairs.
Old shoulder you later.
What do you have? What food do you have?
I got two slices of pizza, some barbecue
fucking
wings, and a salad.
Yeah, the Halo thing. The Halo is actually getting a web series, not a movie. What do you think about web series?
Well, I don't know. The only web series I think I've watched was The Guild. Kind of.
That wasn't too bad. That actually, they got like acting gigs from that stuff. I mean, they were real actors, and they decided to make their own little acting thing.
Yeah. What about Final Fantasy? Final Fantasy had a separate movie. It wasn't related to actual one of the games, but it was
the
a pretty cool
movie.
Oh, The Spirits Within.
No, not Spirits Baldwin. Within. That was a really good film.
I don't know.
Children, that was poop. That was
shit. It was one of those movies where it was like the 3D CG was unnecessary. Like they could have just done it with actors, you know?
Well, I will say that
it didn't make sense
CGI
to me.
Looked good, though.
Look at it now. Look at it now. It's like, it's really creepy.
I don't want to.
What movie again is that? What movie?
Final Fantasy Spirits Within.
They did Advent Children, which is like a sequel to Final Fantasy VII.
Seven.
But it is so fucking bad. Advent Children is so bad.
You don't understand, man.
Because it... Hey, you don't understand.
No, I do understand.
You know what they need to do? You know what they need to do? They need to fucking... They need to go with what they did on that release, on that trailer, the preview of a remake of Final Fantasy VII on the PS3. That's what they need to do for the next PS4.
They're never going to do that.
They just fucking, they need to.
Because you're going
to
have so much QQ and people complaining, oh, this is not like the original. Oh, it doesn't control like the original. It doesn't feel good. Yada, yada, yada.
It's going to be, it would be amazing, though.
But if they already complain about new games, can you imagine them complaining about the remake of an old game? I'm going to tear apart the new Tony Hawk HD. I'm going to rip it to shreds if it doesn't feel like how it should feel. Because that's my childhood destroying. Like you said, hey, just move on then. Move on, you Torque. Stop living in the past.
Hey,
Final Fantasy and Halo are in the past.
But you always talk about Halo. Well, I rarely talk about Final Fantasy VII Remake.
Yeah,
that's
but
the
we can both
I've
live in the past, man.
Hey, okay. Final Fantasy VII was.
Oh my god, there was like a million Final Fantasies, though, wasn't there?
There's like 14.
There's 14.
Like no, but then you get all the
plus
shit.
Two extra.
No, then you got the Crystal Chronicles.
There's about 20.
There's like 50. Don't even shit me. Like,
okay.
Like
I'm not talking about the handheld PS, the handheld Final Fantasies and all the other stupid shit that they had.
Crystal
the
Chronicles
one.
Was a good game.
That so are you gonna shit. Get Halo 4 when it comes out?
I am. I don't know if anyone else is.
I didn't play. Halo.
You know what? I probably will because I skipped Reach. I liked 3. 3 was actually the first game, the first console game where I played online ever. Like, any, like, kind of competitive, like, anything.
You didn't play 2
and I really liked it. Yeah, it was really awesome, and I had a group of friends that I'd play with on a regular basis.
You missed
really
out,
cool.
Diction. 2 online was good. It was real good.
I didn't have an Xbox. I went from PS2, and then, like, 3 years later, I went to Xbox 360, so I skipped Xbox.
Yeah, they literally... Halo 2 was the only online game you played, so literally every time you logged in Xbox Live, people were only playing Halo 2. So it was kind of cool, because every single friend you made on there, they just played Halo. And the custom games, my god, Diction. My god. You should totally get it for the PC.
See, when I first got online with regular Xbox, I played... what was it? Summit. Ghost Recon Summit.
Summit Strike. I had that too.
Summit Strike.
We probably played against each other. I played that a lot as well.
I
remember your name now. I remember it now. I remember it like it was yesterday.
No, it's not. You ignored me for 4 months.
Yeah, but we probably played anyway. But no, that was a good game too until the Ghost Recon decided to get all futuristic-y and stop caring.
Yeah. Did anybody get the new one?
No.
Or play it?
No.
I didn't have any desire to.
Right? Isn't that sad?
I know.
Because Ghost Recon was such a good series, and then
because that was my very first game that I got addicted to. Then I found COD4.
But... I want another Rainbow Six Vegas game.
Well, they're making the Patriot, right?
Oh yeah, they are. I forgot about
but
that.
But it's supposed to be like all like oh no, very deep choices. Oh no, yeah, don't push the guy off the bridge.
Exactly, like the Rainbow Six Vegas 2 is one of my favorite games because it's like it's got the terrorist hunt mode.
Yeah.
You just get with 4 friends, you just get in there with all these weapons you can choose and just like go crazy and use your own tactics or whatever. It was a cool game. The controls are a little bit wonky, but I still really liked it.
Oh, it's good. It's
what angry. About... Hey, Lizzie, did you fall asleep? You there?
No, I'm still here.
She's dying her
you,
hair.
You better...
Yeah, no, I'm not
your input, what's your input on games... that you'd like to see or anticipate?
I don't want to see any more Call of Duties. I think they should leave
Thank
it. You. I don't think they can do anything more with that. Even though I like Call of Duty, but I don't think they should make more because it's just like
I think
pumping out the same thing.
World War II, right, Lizzie? We should go back?
Yeah.
Nope. Go back.
I don't know, but there's like COD 2. I mean, the graphics could be updated on that, but the old Call of Duties were pretty good. You could still play those.
We take the Battlefield 3 engine and we go to World War II. It's as simple as that.
I agree.
It will print money.
But they said World War II's played out.
No, it's not. Now real modern.
Not if you can destroy all the buildings.
I mean,
if you can destroy all the buildings.
I'm loving this company of heroes, you know? That thing's
I think
so
we got to the point where we pretty much did everything, so we're pretty much screwed.
Well, no, I think it's just trends back and forth. You know, 5 years ago, we really outdid World War II. The last 5 years, we've really outdone the modern times. Let's go back in the past.
Yeah,
because every game now is a modern
and then
game.
Lather, rinse, repeat.
Well, what about how far back? Maybe Civil War.
No, I don't want 10 minutes to shoot a gun and reload. I don't want
God
that.
God damn it! They just remake that. Battlefield 1942.
How many times we gotta kill Hitler? Jesus Christ!
Whatever. Hey, what happened in the Korean War? We've never tried that.
That's like the forgotten war almost. Really, no one ever talks about the Korean War.
Wasn't that after World War II?
Yeah.
Then Vietnam?
I think it was before Vietnam.
That was way after.
Desert Storm.
No, I said, yeah, but I said World War II.
It was Korean War, I think, late 50s to early 60s. And almost.
No, Korean War was 51 to 53.
That didn't go into the 60s?
No.
My God. My history. No. It does.
It was only like 2 years.
Well, I was whatchamacallit. I'm under the influence of just as many Americans.
That's
died.
2 years of untapped warfare that we can make so much money off of by shoveling it to these stupid fucking kids who love playing games with guns.
I think the
come on,
I think the problem
we got to get those EA stocks up, man. We just looked at the chart. God damn it!
Yeah, but the problem
is
we still have tensions in Korea right now.
Right, I think that's problem. Some of the problems.
Well, they need to do it to just spark those like. There's political issues over, and then we can have a war and stuff. And then in 30 years, they'll make a game about that war. So
okay,
it's like helping the new generation of people.
First of all, I'm not afraid of North Korea's military powers after that rocket launch, okay?
Well,
second
like...
of all, South Korea is really cool. They're chill people. They have a really awesome film industry. They don't care. They don't give a shit. They'll just make a movie about it, and it'll be awesome.
That's true.
You ever see Old Boy? Come on. Old Boy.
That's for the other ball. It brings up a good point. The Homefront, which was kind of a fad for about a week, and then no one else played it after that.
It was cool because it was John Milius wrote it.
But it was, and... you know, it was North Korea invading.
Yeah, and then he shot him.
Well, I didn't play it.
I think the main part with that game where when I played it was the main characters that you play with in single player. I never really played multiplayer that much, but the single player was horrible in my opinion because you couldn't. They tried to set an emotional thing going on with. It's kind of hard not to spoil it, but someone dies and you're supposed to be sad at the end and it just didn't happen.
Well, so. I mean, how many games nowadays?
they did that with Gears of War 3, and so everyone
I was happy
for a while, being like, "Oh my God, I can't believe they killed Dom." I was like. I don't care. When did you ever care about this character? He's a meathead.
I cared about
He's
him.
A big fucking meathead,
his wife,
dude.
Maria. She loved me.
That was better. That Maria. Was in the second one. That was better.
Well, that was actually.
I just met a girl named Maria.
Damn it, joke. The problem with, I think, a lot of the new age first-person shooters are, it's like they have a standard formula. They have to, like, build up extreme climactic action, and then they have to kill off a main character to make you feel sad. But they've done it so many times now where I don't feel bad if the main characters die. Because they've done it over and over. Literally, every new game, the main character starts to die. Every Call of Duty game, they just kill every American. And, I mean, just... It's weird that that's supposed to be, like, a drama point, and now there's no more drama in it, because we just come to expect the main character to die.
They're all martyrs, man.
Well, dead. So
what
weird.
About... What about... Okay, here we go. At the end of a game that's, you know, no futuristic type concept or anything... But so it's going like Call of Duty or something, and they're going at the end, and then all of a sudden you don't realize what's going to happen, and then aliens come down and suck your body up, and then boom, it becomes a futuristic game.
God damn it, Chuck.
How much you been drinking?
Okay, so you're saying, okay, well, you ever played Prey?
That game was actually pretty good.
That's how the game started. So you're saying we start the game 10 years earlier when Tommy was like a little young Indian kid. And he's like doing his thing.
Yeah,
he's in a bar, whatever. He got beamed up.
Yeah, exactly.
There you go. And then, and then you could either be the alien sticking the probe up somebody's ass, or you could just be like the guy getting it up the ass. Whatever you want to do.
Someone hire this man.
This man has ideas, folks.
Right now, Ubisoft, if you're listening,
you
got your next project right here.
Thank you.
Do you
be
not
here all
anal probe?
How
man?
Are you going
what
to take
call
it?
This?
Should be
how are you going to take it?
On to, man, we didn't even talk about Mass Effect 3 that much. We talked about other stuff, but you guys have seen 38 Studios, correct?
Yes.
Well, Curt Schilling, I mean, what do you think?
He's a douche.
He's a douche. Just because he pitched for the Red Sox doesn't make him a douche.
He's a douche.
Well, he's a douche with no money now. He lost $50 million of his own money.
I hope he loses more.
And I think it was $79 million.
Still don't know who he is. Who is this guy?
Okay, he was a whatchamacallit. He was a baseball player for the Red Sox, an avid game player, and he wanted to get into the game industry. And he created a studio called 38. Was it 38 Industries? 38. I think it's just 38 Studios.
38 Studios. Yeah.
And the first game that they were doing was called Kingdoms of Amalur Reckoning. Kingdoms of Amalur. It was someone else's games, but they pretty much slapped the lore and the title to it in a way to generate some cash, because their first actual project was going to be an MMO, and they blew through around $109 million, and nothing got done for it.
This is Grandma's Boy 2.
Did they have some good dinners, though?
These executives got paid well.
There you go.
But everyone else kind of went to hell.
So what's going on?
They're bankrupt, and he lost $50 million of his own money, and he's sad.
Okay, we move on.
Okay, cool. did anyone actually play Kingdoms of Amalur? Kingdoms of Amalur? No?
No. I did.
Did you like it?
I played. I still have a character and everything. It is legitimate. Like, okay, graphically, nothing special. Uh-huh. But as an RPG, like, my biggest problem with RPG games is that the combat comes second. And so whenever you get into combat situations, it usually feels kind of lackluster.
That's true.
This game, they put it forward. So you've got, imagine God of War, except like 10 different types of weapon styles, and each one has different animations and everything for how you kill these people. It's really cool. And the story itself is, you know, it's standard fantasy fare, but like for a 60-hour game, like the fact that the combat is always really fun and satisfying,
yeah,
I thought that was really cool that they put that first.
So good game, just unfortunate that they shot for an MMO after it and then just killed it.
Exactly, yes, yeah.
Oh man, I think MMOs are going to be a dying thing relatively soon. People try and copy WoW. WoW is its own thing. Why do I want to play a copy? I'll just play WoW. And that's my motto.
Don't you think WoW's going to go away eventually, and then some bigger and better but the same concept's going to come out?
Eventually, and never. Hopefully, but they have a lot of subscribers, and a lot of people there are so invested in WoW, where literally every new expansion, you just have hundreds of thousands of people resubscribe to it, because they're like, well, okay, I'll check it out and see what's going on. Mm. It's a disease, Junk. It's a disease.
I've never gotten linked. Because you said you signed back on this month.
Possibly, maybe. Yes.
You did. You told me you did.
I did. And I have a funny story.
You're back on the WoW?
Well, I was watching call. I joined.
You didn't know? Yeah, he signed up, I think, last week or the week before.
Yeah.
What the fuck? Yeah,
exactly last
well,
week.
What happened was I was playing, and I'm like, all right, yes, let's resubscribe. And I did. But I had a funny story. I was with a group of people, 40 others, and we were going to take over the main town, the enemy's main town. And
then before you ran in, you went, Leroy Jenkins!
No, I'm a healer, so I don't do that. But but
you could still if you wanted to.
I could, but then I'd be immediately slower. But anyway, we ran with all 40 of us, and we're running to the main city. And I got displaced a bit after we killed the boss, because I'm not used to the enemy city, so I didn't know where we were going. I followed the wrong idiot, and I got lost in the tram station. So as I'm just trying to leave...
Did you say a tram?
Yeah, it's a tram station.
Which tram?
I was in Stormwind.
Tramps?
You got lost in Stormwind?
I got lost in Stormwind.
Really?
Yes.
Wow. Okay.
So
okay.
I got lost in Stormwind, and after I eventually made it out, I had the tram station. I didn't know where I was going, and I was able to sneak past everyone. And I got on a boat, but just so happened that people were going to be raiding our town or intercept the group we were having, where I got on the wrong boat, and I thought it was my group that was there, but instead it was about 30 Alliance characters as I stepped on the boat, and then I was just spawn killed repeatedly on the boat. So that was no fun. So note to me, never know which boat you're going on.
So you went on the wrong boat.
I went on the wrong boat.
And you got spanked.
Yeah, a little bit, by 30 people.
They like pulled you in the back.
Well, I walk onto the boat because I thought they were my friends.
I'm gonna show you something.
No, that's not how it goes. But from far away, I thought it was just like our group of people. I didn't think the Alliance had rounded up people, and I walked in until I realized everyone's red, and then and I died really horribly too.
Was it like a slow motion?
No, it wasn't slow motion. It was pretty much instant because 100,000 really doesn't last that long anymore nowadays.
You have to go out in style next time.
No, I died immediately. No style.
I like Sean Bean getting shot with arrows, like slow motion.
No.
How do you get off the ship then?
You can just take a resurrection at like the spirit healer, but you lose some of your durability, or you just try and get lucky and like spawn in and run away real quickly.
But you gotta jump off the ship then.
Yeah. It's not fun dying on the moving object. Good stuff though.
They were probably laughing.
Yeah, they probably were, because they're like, look at this idiot.
I imagine they were.
They were saying, come on, boy!
That is disgusting on every level.
All right, so what's this Dead or Alive 5 boobs?
What do you mean? What is Dead or Alive and boobs?
I know that's all it is, boobs, but why are we doing a topic about it?
Because don't you like Dead or Alive? And don't you like boobs?
I don't know who doesn't. Maybe Jan. Do you like boobs?
No.
Well, I'm just saying. I don't know. People will give their life five, or their life in general.
Holy shit!
Well, they'll give their life crap in general just because they feel like it isn't a, like an actual fighting game. But it is really good. It's a really good fighting game. And it's probably my favorite fighting game, but no, they're doing it. If you pre-order it, you get access to swimsuit, bikinis, and other stuff. And you could buy their, I think they have a collector's edition, and it includes more weird, perverted things.
Show another picture.
Do you think it's wrong selling a game for, like, sex?
Well, I mean, I don't know. Right now, if you...
No.
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 I mean...
It's kind of like some other...
Sex is used in everything. There's nothing wrong with that now. That's like the norm of society.
They say, though, at least what I've learned, that sex doesn't actually sell. It will make you remember the product, but it actually doesn't contribute to selling the product. And
sex sells, I can't argue with that, but it's just, you know, there's like a line you got to draw
sometimes.
What
do you mean? Come on. Who doesn't like chicks beating each other up in bikinis?
I'm just saying, man.
Jesus.
Wait, didn't you buy Lollipop Chainsaw?
Hey, I bought that.
Play, okay. All right.
And I did not get the achievement either for looking up their skirt. So.
Well, good on you.
You guys can look it up. I haven't got that yet.
Well, I just have a question.
I still need to get that.
How can you not? Like, from the gameplays I've seen, it's pretty much every 5 minutes there is an upskirt shot.
Yeah, but when you like try and do it, she like covers it. So like there's like an animation, so like she like puts her hand on her ass.
What
and then
game
she
was
puts
that?
Her hand in front.
On this Resident Evil did that, right? Resident Evil 4. If you tried to look up Ashley's skirt, you got yelled at.
Dear God.
You did, right? She would like call you a pervert. I'm pretty sure that's what happened.
Isn't she like 16?
I'm gonna go play that right
that's
now.
It. We're going to the internet. We're gonna find out. Because I'm pretty sure.
Right, Resident Evil 4.
Resident Evil 4. Ashley.
So that's like a president's daughter then.
Yeah. There you go. Resident Evil 4. Ashley's skirt. What? Oh, wait. Upskirt Z-Lock glitch. We got some perverts on the internet.
Oh, my. Let's see here.
Sound surprised.
Look up Ashley's skirt without her stopping you for Resident Evil 4. Here we go.
Why don't you just, like, go on porn? I don't understand.
Yeah, why would you try and look up a video game character skirt? Why not a real girl skirt? Although I wouldn't advise that to
right?
anyone.
Right? Like, wouldn't that be, like, bad?
Yeah, don't do that.
No, you yourself. Put...
Oh, you, like, pervert.
Okay, hold on. If
put mirrors on your
here,
shoes.
If you...
that way
yeah,
you
I was going to say, put mirrors on your shoes right,
so
or just
says,
get one of those
here,
bags.
Right here. Oh, I got this right here. When she hooks a rope to the boat on top of a cliff, she says, I have some business to take care of. While she is saying that, look at her skirt, especially when she goes to jump up.
Well, here, right here, if you listen to the chat real quick, this is the pretty much one of the scenes where every time you try and look it up, right here.
Oh, you pervert!
Oh, God, we got a YouTube video.
Hey!
Watching.
What are you looking at?
So, it's pretty funny.
Oh, my God.
Oh, yeah.
This guy's probably in jail right now for being a pedophile, by the way. This is probably Sandusky right here.
Sandusky. Oh, since oh that guy, the guy who what he got indicted on 40
counts.
He's
in the video games too.
Oh yeah, dude, 40 counts, and I think one was his stepson. That guy's fucked up. That guy
fucking
deserves Sandusky. Yeah, that guy deserves a rotten hell. God,
look up to him.
Develop an emotional connection.
I like
chill Dusky.
So, all right, so when is the game coming out?
Which Resident Evil 4?
No, Dead or Alive.
Dead or Alive 5, I believe, is coming out in October. Right. I'm going to get it. Yeah. Not for any other reason besides that I love the Dead or Alive 4. I probably put
well,
in
you
the
and I never finished Dead or Alive. We were supposed to play Dead or Alive.
Well, the Extreme Beach Volleyball game. This isn't that.
Yeah.
No, this isn't the volleyball. This is the fighting game. The volleyball game
wow.
is creepy.
Oh, yeah. I sucked at those because you had to have all the... That's a game where... Isn't that the style of game where people get those video game, the joystick boxes?
Some of them do, yeah.
With buttons on it and all that crap?
Yeah.
Because it's a cage like fighting games and all that
for the
crap.
Most part, yeah. But
yeah, that's just
chill. Have you ever played Sandusky Football Manager 2012?
Well, he invited me over one time to play that, so I don't know if that counts. But speaking, before, if we stay on the boobs, before we talk about Steam style.
Boobs!
Did you finish the game, Rager?
Not yet. I'm like not even that far into
it. Is
it
a good game
like
or no?
I'm only an hour into it, but the mechanics of the game are not that great. It's kind of like repetitive, but you know, overall, it's got like a comic book style to it, so it's pretty cool visually looking.
Boobs.
Yeah, there's boobs in it.
That's
head chopping off.
I like boobs.
What did you say?
I don't know. I enjoy it. It's just one of those games where you enjoy. I don't know about replay value because I haven't finished the whole game yet, but I enjoy playing through it, even though it's repetitive. So.
Well, I mean, is it? What would you have to say is more fun, Dead Rising or that?
Probably Dead Rising because that's co-op. So.
Yeah, Dead Rising does have co-op.
What was that noise you just made? It was like.
That's why I think about stuff like. I don't know.
That's what happens when he thinks. That's why you don't hear it that often. Moving on. So, wait, did anyone else play the Jessica Negron game?
Review on.
I'm still playing it. I was gonna do a recording session.
Is it,
on
is it good or no?
Other things. Yeah, it's fun.
I think you ran out of tissues.
It's weird, but it's funny. Like the boyfriend, his head attached. He's got some funny things to say every now and then. But it's weird. Like there's this one part, like you're in the school and you're going around and you gotta like rescue like 8 survivors or something. And you free this one dude and he's like, I can't remember her name. What's the character's name?
Jessica Negri.
Juliet.
Yeah, Juliet. Yeah. He's like, thanks, Juliet. Just so you know, I'm gonna think of you when I masturbate tonight. And it's just like, what? Why did I just say?
And she's like, okay, bye.
Yeah, she's just like super okay about anything sexual.
Well, Jessica Negri was, so I was okay with that. She wanted to join us. She wanted to join us in the DBEs.
That's pretty cool.
DBE, man.
Yeah, the
DBE. We have to get her in at Chronocasters. She joined us when it wasn't called Chronocast, so we got to get her in at least one time.
She's got to talk about a great game.
Is the game DBE, like, when... Is it like, the guys versus girls type thing? Because, like, I don't want to be... I don't know, because I don't want to have the risk of, like, having someone, like, you know...
Splooge on your face?
Yeah. No, on your leg. You have to aim for the leg.
No, you aim for the knee. Aim for the knee.
Aim for the knee there. I don't want someone's jism on my knee. I don't think anyone does. It's like, oh, look at this.
Well,
there's the point in
Jan.
Oh, that's just wrong.
Well, Junk, you're not allowed to play.
Jessica's idea.
Probably right.
No, we are right.
You're not allowed to play, Junk.
I want
to
play it. I should play it and videotape
didn't
me
you get
playing
your
it.
No, what?
You're on your own. You're gonna be in your own lobby.
Yeah,
that.
You're getting kicked out, man. You're on your own team. I'm not playing that with you, Junk. But
all right,
I guess we'll see when you guys actually finish it if it was worth the $60 investment.
Oh, it is.
Oh God, Steam sales. How's your wallet? Is your wallet preparing?
Oh yeah.
I can't wait.
I'm gonna buy so much shit.
Oh, Steam sales coming up.
Yeah.
What kind of games are coming out?
They got like a sale every day, it seems like.
Everything.
All right, what games? I want to get some good games. Well, I just picked up the whatchamacallit, and I'm really excited about that. Company of Heroes, and that's so much fun.
Yeah.
Company of Heroes is really good. But, I mean, literally every game they have, I don't know how they do it, how they're able to do it. It just everything is just like 90% off. How can you not be excited?
When is it coming?
It is coming
next week?
Soon. We don't know.
Awesome.
We'll find out soon enough.
So it's like a summer sale then? Summer time?
Well, yeah, it's the Steam summer sales.
Last time they had a thing where you got a game and you got like some kind of, what was that?
The summer camp sale.
You got like a token or something. If you get
like awards and shit.
Yeah.
I didn't do that. That was like a plot just so they could rape your wallet.
Yeah, well, if you look at the picture on here, this is sale time.
No, Steam, no.
So, yeah, that's... But it's a good thing. I mean, there's nothing wrong with it. It's just it happens where I buy games that I never even play. Oh, for $1? Yeah, what the hell? Why not? And then you never play.
Yeah, they had last summer. They had GTA San Andreas, GTA 4, and the DLCs, what, Gay Tony and stuff. They had that as like a collective $5. Package. It was like £6. I was like, what the fuck? So I bought that.
You're going to pay £6. We're going to pay $5.
I'll be like the happiest guy ever if I see Pro Cycling Manager 2012 like at $10.
Do you really want that game?
I thought it'd be fun. See how it plays out. I heard it's got multiplayer. You can like tag team with people and stuff.
I still have to play Train Simulator. Someone gifted me that.
Yeah, that's kind of boring.
Poor people.
Is it?
Yeah.
I can't imagine how it would be exciting.
I bought it
at
full price at like $40.
So you go straight right on the tracks. You just kind of go.
What makes you go backwards and pick up cars and go forward and switch tracks and all that other bullshit?
That sounds even more boring than just going straight.
It makes sure you switch them tracks.
I'm curious to see. So we don't know when it's going to come out.
No,
we don't know.
It is going to happen on a Monday, though. From I believe the last 2 years, they are Mondays, so it happens on.
All right, so we got
it's like
sure
a whole week
tweet it out.
It starts after the weekend sales, and then boom, it starts on the Monday and goes for an entire.
Oh no, really?
Isn't it a week?
Oh,
it's like 2 weeks, I thought. Sometimes
I'm gonna be in Canada, so I can't even use like I can't buy.
No. Do you have a
phone?
The app on your phone.
No.
They made it. We'll do that. You can now buy games and set them so that they'll be ready
yeah,
to install.
Yeah, but my thing will be on Rogers, so. That'll like
the
cost
Roger.
What the hell's
Roger? Rogers is like,
don't
give
your
phone
to
Rogers.
Roger.
Who the hell is Roger?
Mr. Rogers died.
What?
It's a phone company in Canada.
So?
Just let it
it's
be.
A Steam app. You get the Steam app, you buy it, and there you go.
Yeah, but like, it's going to say, oh, it's going to recognize that I'm in Canada. That's the whole point.
So?
So that's a clash because mine is registered to my card, which is in the UK. Every time I've been in Canada trying to buy a game, it says, no, you can't buy this.
Yeah, but
because you're
shouldn't
in-
it be like a Steam app that's loading on to your actual account and it'll recognize you have a British account?
If it's on your phone,
this
thing
with
fraud.
It's just, yeah.
Just get like Todd. Get Todd to log into your account and buy what
oh,
you
yeah,
want.
Oh, yeah. Just do that.
Or
look at it on your phone.
Give Todd 100 and tell him to buy everything you want and then he'll just gift it to you, you know, whatever.
Well, just use your PayPal. Just like give him your PayPal password and then change.
Exactly,
it.
But when you come back, you may not have any money in there. He may have all the games. So that's an issue too.
Does your like account information? Does that keep like payment details? Because then you could just do it straight from your account.
Actually, no. I could just get my mom to like. I'd give.
You're
like,
trusting your mother to
get
pick
my mom
out games?
To buy it like via her card, and then I just pay her back. I can do that. Never mind.
That's.
I like how everyone was just like, "What the fuck is Rogers? What the fuck?"
Because no one knows who the Rogers is.
It's a phone
Rogers
company.
Is a phone
well, that's
company.
Like saying,
hey,
what the
too.
Hell's a Time Warner? You know, you,
like for
you
instance,
this.
I know what Time
well,
Warner
go away.
Is. I've seen commercials.
I know
yeah,
it too.
Stupid child Italian face.
They've Rogers also got, they've got Bell and they've got Telus and stuff. And you guys have like Fios and Comcast.
Yeah.
Well, stop learning about America. Go back to your Canada land.
You don't want to learn about
Utorik,
Comcast, trust me.
When you go to Canada, are you going to be going to Callaway?
Am I going to be where?
Going to Callaway. The amusement
Callaway.
Park.
Oh. I don't think so. No. The only amusement park I know is on the Banff Road, which heads out to the Rockies. It's on like the left of the road. I have no
I
idea.
Like
I don't know any amusement.
It's
park.
On
I wouldn't
road.
Know,
I mean,
I wouldn't know
America
park.
For the amusement.
Oh wait, no, that is Callaway.
That's
oh,
your
then
point.
That, yeah, it's got like this one roller coaster. I don't like amusement parks. I hate them.
I don't go on roller coasters because I'm too scared to go on them. But me and my friend are going to see if we can get time off and go up there for Callaway.
You guys should totally make a vlog together.
Aww. Me and my friend, we have a vlog channel together.
Actually. You mean your real channel? Because you deleted your YouTube account?
Oh, God. Here we go again.
Not this shit. Fuck you.
Why don't you care about YouTube like we care about
Why
YouTube?
Why did you have to destroy YouTube?
Yeah.
Why did you do it?
Because making money off of YouTube means nothing to me, so...
What about
I already
that?
Have a full-time job. What about
this
song?
Whole thing.
Make money
that
or... Jen, there were 2,000 people that love to hear you every single day.
I still have a channel that people can go subscribe to. I uploaded a video today,
Never happened.
Actually.
You destroyed your YouTube account.
Was it an orange? Were you cleaning an orange? I want to see that one.
Cleaning an orange.
No, I was crushing. I was crushing an orange. And then there was another one where I was crushing a kiwi. Two kiwis, actually.
Crushing two kiwis.
Yeah, kiwis.
Yes.
You know,
I found them... And it's not like I was going to eat them because someone could, like, you know, did something to them. So I just...
Who's going to poison the kiwi?
Hey, you never know what people could do,
That's
okay?
That's the worst plan
Plus,
ever.
Yeah, but hotel rooms are absolutely disgusting and filthy because 81% of a hotel room is covered in feces. So
81%?
Yeah, they were just...
Are you
they
serious?
Were just,
tell me
they
these
were
things
sitting,
I'm going to hotel.
You're doing a bad job of cleaning if 81% is covered
no,
in feces.
No, no, no. It was... Yeah, but guess what? It was a study done in the United States.
Well, I'll blame our American maids.
Yeah, there you go. So, Yeah, they were just sitting on the desk, so I figured, I'm like, I don't know if this would be good, so I just threw them out. And they're kind of mushy anyway, so I figured I would just
kiwis.
Throw them out, and yeah.
Well.
Also, another thing I was going to mention earlier before I was interrupted was I was excited about the Tony Hawk HD, because that's the one that's exactly the same as the original on Nintendo 64,
Doesn't that
right?
Slower, though, like the other ones?
Well, it should be
but
a remake of the PS1 type one.
Well, it was on PS1 and N64 and stuff, but it's the exact that's the one that's the exact remake they're coming out with,
it
right?
It should be, yeah.
Yeah, I used to play that religiously when I was a kid, N64.
I played that a lot with my sister. Me and her would always play, like, skate or, you know, horse and stuff, so I'm pretty excited about that. I'll probably buy that.
Well, that is good. It'd be awesome, though, if you had a YouTube channel to play it on. That would be cool.
I do have a YouTube channel, but guess what? It's going to be on Xbox or PS3, and I don't have a PVR, so I can't record.
That would be cool if you had a PVR.
Oh, remember that?
God. And a YouTube channel.
Well, I don't...
That's why I need your YouTube money.
I don't have anything to capture
guys,
with.
We need to start up a... everyone needs to chip in some money to get her a PVR because she needs to start recording again.
No, I will not make people give me money to buy a PVR. I will not let that. No.
Then you gotta go prostitute yourself then? What are you going to do?
Be a prostitute. Screw you.
Well, you're already at a hotel, so I mean, it is convenient.
Oh!
There are a lot of creepy people like that who'd probably go for it, but the stunt's only not gonna do that. That's crazy. Are you kidding me?
Like, hey, baby. You already got the costume and everything. I have to pay for anything.
Well, I don't have a French maid's outfit. I don't have, like, the classic French maid outfit.
See, there's your problem.
Yeah.
Okay, real life stuff besides prostituting yourself in a hotel for money, for PVR. Is anyone else? Yeah. Junk, you have real life stuff because you're old.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
Real life things as far as what's going on right now or things that's passed or just a story?
Yeah, just what's a good story or anything.
Well, you know, I was thinking about actually, you know, what we were talking about earlier about admitting to your parents about things you did when you were a kid. And I still remember when we were all getting together. I think I was 22, 23, and my brothers were a little bit older, and we're all sitting there, we're laughing, and we started telling stories. And I started sharing stories of things that I pretty much a confession, you know, confession to my parents of things that I was doing. But I always found a good way to tell the story. You know, it was definitely always comical, add some comedy to it, and the whole family would just, everybody would laugh about it. And I started, and I remember telling these stories. And then my brother chimed in. He goes, okay, I got a story I got to tell you. And he started telling the story about how the van got the windshield smashed. And I looked at him, and I was behind my mom and my dad, and I'm waving my arms. Don't tell him that story. Don't tell him that story. And sure enough, he confessed, and he told the story of what happened to the windshield.
Oh, God.
And I still remember the mood in the room just went from a huge high to a huge low.
All because of that?
Yeah, because I remember that because it was during a time when basically – I mean, the reason the windshield got smashed is because we were in the van and we were squirting people with a fire extinguisher.
That's pretty dumb junk.
Yeah. And we got in a car chase and they smashed our windshield with a Coca-Cola bottle. And
how the hell did you do that?
So my brother, I guess he felt that the need to confess. I still remember that. And it was just like, but he felt good because he got it off his shoulders. So that was a story. The moral of the story is if you are going to confess, you really probably don't want to or shouldn't. And I'm just, that's just my thoughts of the hour.
This is definitely the morals. So like the really deep and secret seedy shit don't say.
Oh yeah, keep that shit secret.
Okay.
Oh yeah. Definitely. Yeah, there's a point of
value people.
So. Yeah, but like, what if you want to tell them? Like, if you're being a little creepy. I don't know.
It's twofold. If you want to tell them to obviously make yourself feel better, that's sort of something you should really consider how they're going to feel.
Well, the idea is to make them feel bad and you feel better, right?
Yeah, but that's not right.
Oh, it's a douche thing, but that's the idea behind it.
Well, yeah. I mean, if your parents are douchey and you want to get back at them, that's a different story altogether.
I stole the flowers when I was 5. You thought it was the dog.
Yeah.
Does anyone else have anything enlightening of their stories of childhood memories and/or pain, suffering?
Ooh, I got a good one.
I was never a bad child, so.
Who's there? Who's first?
Rager's got a good one. He said.
Rager. I got a good one about my schooling. It's gonna bore everyone.
Oh, joy.
Yeah.
Bore us away then.
This was back before, you know, you could get progress reports online. So this is like back in 2000, I think.
You can get progress reports online?
I think so.
Yeah.
What?
Okay.
Well, pretty much, your
parents just like sign up with like an email thing with some school website and then it'll send it to you. But I never had that because my parents are too stupid.
We just now got that here. But before that, we got our progress reports in the mail. And I was doing horrible in all my classes, so every single time one got sent to my mailbox, I would take it and hide it, like, in my closet or something. Then one day when parent-teacher conferences came, you know, I went over to my neighbor's house. I knew my mom was going to come back from parent-teacher conferences and kill me. She thought I was doing amazing in class. She thought I was getting, like, A's and everything. And I was, like, failing every single class I was taking except for lunchtime. So pretty much she came back. She drove her minivan all the way up to my friend's house, which was, like, 10 miles away, grabbed me from the trampoline we were jumping on, dragged me to the fucking van, slammed the door, and my friend thought she killed me. Like, was, I never seen my mom that mad in my entire life. She was so embarrassed in the conferences because she thought, you know, I was doing good and stuff. So I felt kind of bad too later on, but I got ground for like a good 6 months and my N64 taken away. I was pissed.
Yeah. Did you get your grades, start working your grades back up?
Yeah, occasionally. But because I had nothing else to do with that 6 months, because I'd be gaming all the time on my N64, you know, getting all those Banjo-Kazooie and all that other bullshit. You know, those games you spend hours on playing, trying to get collectible stuff. You just get all the collectibles, and then I have to get every single thing if I play a game. You know, I have to do every single thing. Now I can't do that because I got other stuff to do. But
you're an old
back
person.
Back in the day, I had to do everything in the game, and like get all the collectibles, get everything, or else I'd feel bad about myself, and I wouldn't stop thinking about it until I got them all.
That's not good.
Yeah. I'd not do my homework until I got every single one of them.
Now, have you ever told your mom, thank you for pulling me off those games due to the fact that I concentrated better on school that semester?
Yeah, it's kind of a mutual thing where
games
made me happy back in the day because I had shit friends. My friends sucked. Pretty much games was my escape from everything I had going on. So when they took away my games, I was pretty much lost. All I had was schoolwork.
But
when all you have is schoolwork is bad. So
oh, come on.
You gotta have something in between schoolwork. But...
Well, you already had your fun.
In jail.
Now turn the story around or find a story inside there. Is there something in regards to that you like to go ahead and confess to your parents?
Right now, if they were listening?
Yeah, if they were listening and tell them.
They were listening. God help them. Oh, my God. But I don't really have – they laugh about it now, so.
Well, there you go. That's
one
good,
of those
then.
Things where, like, oh, remember that time when you hit all your progress reports? I'm like, yeah, I remember that. I remember I got beat and then my N64 taken away.
At least you can tell about it now.
Yeah, I remember I kicked your ass pretty good there, didn't I? I can see. Yeah, that's definitely good.
Well, Junk, as a father, what's the worst punishment you've dealt out to your daughters?
What's the worst punishment?
Yeah.
Just, I ground them. I mean, you know, you take everything away from them. But
that's so lackluster.
How long do you ground them for?
You know, unfortunately, you know, knock on wood, my kids are actually really good. You know, I'm a stern father. You know, I tell them exactly what I expect out of them, what I expect them to do. And if you don't do it, you're going to not enjoy something. You know, either take their phone away, now with my youngest kid, I could take the car away and I could take those type of things. But when it comes, you know, and I guess like my oldest daughter, when she was driving, you know, there's a strict rule. You don't talk on the phone when you're driving.
It's illegal.
You just don't do it.
It's illegal. You can get you can get a $250 ticket.
Right. So you just don't do it. And so my oldest daughter, she goes ahead and states, you know, I don't talk on the phone when I'm driving. I said, good. You know, and I believed her. Of course, I want to believe her. So all of a sudden, I get this letter in the mail stating the fact that my daughter is all of a sudden, I get
a criminal,
a letter.
A convict. Felon.
Well, no, I get a letter from the city of Aurora. Going a speeding light ticket, going through a photo thing. So I open it up, and who do I see? I see my daughter going through a red light with the phone in her freaking hand.
Oh.
The photo.
Oh,
so she
God.
Gets home that night, and I said, you're not talking on the phone when you're driving, right? And she goes, of course not, Dad. I'm not doing that. And I said, you've never gone through any red lights or anything like that, right? She goes, of course not, Dad. What are you thinking? And I went, bam, look at this. So I showed her the picture and the photo, and she, like, crushed. And then, and so I grounded her. I took the car away for 2 months. And she had to take the school bus and all that.
Was she mad at you for that?
That I took the car away?
Yeah.
No, I laughed about it. No, she understood. No, she knew. And with all my groundings, if my kids do something really bad, they always have the opportunity to get the sentence not so long. So the end result is that she I think it only ended up being about a month because she was really good for that month. So
that's like very much like the good behavior in jail type thing.
Good behavior sentencing. You know, you get 2 months, no car, and but she had to use her phone, but she had to take the school bus every day, so she didn't get a car for a 2 months in her senior year.
Did you call her a criminal at all? Like while she was like leaving or entering the house, did you just call her a criminal?
Yeah, pretty much. And what sucked is the letter came in my name, and I had to write a letter, make photocopies of my license, and saying this is not, and a picture of me. This is not me. Send the letter to my daughter, and I gave the full name, and they have her pay for it. So I sent that to the city of Aurora. Aurora did the whole thing, and they sent the letter back in my daughter's name, and she had to pay the ticket.
So, ouch.
Wow.
Yep, it was good. So it was on her record, not mine.
So, ouch.
And that was a stern thing I did as a father. Where did Lizzie go? Did she fall asleep?
She said something came up.
Not an erection.
I like how she added that in there. Something came up, not an erection.
Well, someone made the joke. Oh, God. Anyone else with some real life stuff?
What's the worst punishment you guys received from your parents?
Worst punishment?
Pretty much just sent to my room. That's pretty much it. Nothing too bad.
This is going to sound kind of weird, but my dad used to sit on me when I was a little kid. No, okay. But it was like because I was rambunctious, right? So I would like...
Loved. Leave me alone.
It was like a way of like keeping me still so I would calm the fuck down and not be so angry. And it worked. But it was like at the time, or like even now, I'm like, that was kind of weird, but I guess my dad knew what he was doing because I no longer, you know, get rambunctious like that anymore.
Well, that's good because then you'd break all your electronic shit and that would not be good.
Exactly.
Yeah. I remember one time I got sent to my room and I don't know what I did. I did something stupid. And my parents were having a gathering of people. They had a whole bunch of people over and they said, go to your room and just don't come out. And it's like, okay, whatever, blah, blah, blah. And I was all upset. And I remember climbing out of the window, went into the mountain. We used to live next to the hills. And I went hiking in the hills, wandered around there. I actually found this little area, a tree and a grassy area, and fell asleep for a while. And then I ended up coming back and climbed through the window. And they were still having the party, so I went to sleep. And so, like, the next day or the day after, I told my mom, you know, I left the house. And she goes, you did? I said, yeah, well, because I was so mad at you because you put me in the room, blah, blah. And I left. And she goes, God, I didn't even know you left. Oh, well, no wonder it was so quiet. I was like.
Hopefully you don't get kidnapped, Junk, because that would be bad.
Yeah, that would have been bad. But, no, that's all right. God, there's so many guys. I mean, obviously, has any of you guys ever run away?
No.
No, I've never done that.
I was afraid of the consequences.
Yeah.
I never ran away overnight, but I ran away, you know, for 7 hours, 8 hours type thing. But I always came back.
Yeah, that's the type of thing that they would call the cops on, basically. So you get in big trouble.
No, if I ran away, I'd have to call the cops because I'd get killed if I came back. So that was my problem. It was, you know, you got that, like, I don't know. Like, I was always afraid of my father. I still am. That something, maybe do something wrong. Something bad's gonna happen. Just something not.
Yeah, I remember my oldest brother ran away. He was gone for like 2.5 weeks or something like that.
2.5 weeks.
And he ended up, he rode his bike, and we didn't know where the heck he went. And he ended up showing up at my grandparents' house, and my grandparents called us and said, "Hey, he was just here, and he's leaving right now. So, and he's apparently going this direction. See if you can go get him." And so I remember all of us jumped in the car and we went driving looking for him, and I still don't know how the hell my dad did it, because back then there was no phones, no you know, it was we were in a freaking station wagon with the window going down in the back, you know. And I still remember that my parents found him on riding his bike on the side of the road. I remember my mom crying because she was so happy. And my dad's going, and he pulls over, and he gets right behind him, and he honks a horn, and he pulled over. And my brother actually was very happy to see us, and we all went out to a good meal, and because my parents never took us out to dinner. And they were all very happy and jubilant that we were all together. And I was just happy because we went out to dinner.
You didn't get your ass beat? Or he didn't get his ass beat?
No, I don't think so. I don't recall him getting in trouble.
Because, really?
Yeah, I don't know what the circumstances were, why he left. I don't know any of that. So I don't remember.
Unknown circumstances.
Yeah.
That's weird.
Anyway, so that was another little gosh. I mean, obviously there's millions of stories that have been around for freaking ever. But
yeah, you're old like a fossil.
Yeah, so that he ran away. My twin brother ran. He ran away for like a month.
Chuck, why is everyone running away?
I don't know. He just wanted to run away from life, though. He ran away from all the crap that was going on in back home, and he just wanted to leave. So he just left. Oh, see, you're so adorable. Look at you, child.
Well, someone asked for a picture.
No.
He's so adorable.
Would you ever, Junk, if one of your kids ran away, would you beat them or would you just be happy that they came back?
No, I'd be happy. I mean, I don't, you don't want any harm done to your parent, your kids in any way, shape, or form.
But you got to prevent them from doing it again.
Right. I mean, well, you just get I got handcuffs and you lock them in the bedroom.
That's probably how people go to jail.
My dad would have spanked me like 10 million times.
Yeah.
I got spankings.
Yeah. Well, but that's so frowned upon now as far as spanking. You know?
That is true.
Just like,
I turned out okay, right?
You know, hey, did I spank my kids? Did I spank my kids when they were younger? Yes. Because they had to learn, you know? There's a point where, you know, you got to learn. And so did I spank them? Yes. Do I spank? Obviously not. They're older now, so you don't touch them now, nor do I want to. Now I care less what the hell they do. You know, as long as they don't spend my money, I'm okay.
That's a good motto.
When your kids were younger, did you yell at them a lot or no?
When yelling was due, yeah. I have two stages of yelling. I got one yelling when it's a stern yell, and do the right stuff, and it's okay. And then I have another stage where if they hit the button and I lose it, which I lose it, they run and hide, is what it comes down to. Because you don't want to see.
When was the last time that happened?
It's been a while. It's been a while. And I hate getting that mad because I just don't like me when I get that mad. But it's at the point where they hit a button and They know where that button is, and
they touched anyway.
And if every once in a while they test it,
just keep poking that button.
Yeah, they hit that button. So
maybe you should just disable the button.
Well, I don't. I try to. You know, that's why I got the basement. That's why I got man's land. I come down here. This is my cave. Get the hell out. You know,
my sanctuary.
This is mine. That's why when the girls come down here, you see me get the hell out. You guys hear me when they come down.
I hear nothing.
Yeah.
Yeah. Get the hell out. I don't want you here. This is my man.
I hear nothing.
This is my cave.
When
go
you're
away.
You learn that when you're Italian. I didn't hear anything. Nothing.
Yeah. Yeah. So I mean your dad never came. When you were down, you had your whole setup in the basement.
Yeah, for the most part. And yeah, I was left alone for a good time. But it was nice too because literally the sound didn't travel upstairs. So pretty much you could just be as loud as you want. No one heard it. Nowadays, it's you can hear whatever I say right below me, which is rather annoying.
Well, because you're upstairs now.
Yeah, because you can't leave in the basement.
Why did you not leave it in the basement?
Because when you're in the basement, you become a mole man. And then when you're a mole man, bad things happen. Like, I got sensitive to light. Like, I saw light, and I was like, ah! It wasn't good.
I liked having my office upstairs, but it got to the point where I had to stop doing everything about 8 o'clock because that's when my wife and kids had to go to sleep. So that's why I moved it all down to the basement. And I like it down here though; it's a lot more room down here.
No, it was nice, but literally what annoyed me the most, I don't know if you get it, the buzzing of the lights, because you obviously need to keep the lights on, and they would just buzz and they would hum, and that would just fuck with my mind because I'm like, what the hell is that noise?
Oh, I hate when lights come.
Yeah, exactly.
That annoys the shit out of me.
And yes, that's a llama. It's a cool llama too, and it spit at me afterwards.
You remind me of that guy from the bench warmers that goes outside and he's like, oh, the light!
I'm telling you.
And like, slams the door.
Actually watch that movie?
Yeah, it's a good movie. I liked it.
No. What the hell is that, Rager?
What the fuck?
Oh my god. That's not a real person, is it?
That's me.
In your dreams.
That's not a real person.
He's
that's,
a cloud. He's going to float away.
That's an exaggerated video.
That's
picture,
me, like,
right?
That's me 10 years ago.
When you 18? That's what happened?
All right. Oh, I just tell me that's not a real person, right?
That's that's probably is a real person, actually.
I'm a real person, dude.
He's a real boy.
Why would somebody want to do that to themselves?
Because he's hot, man. He's the shit.
They can make a lot of money.
He looks like a mutant.
Oh, well. He can crush you in between his thighs.
What are you trying to say, John Kong? What are you trying to say?
He can crush us in between his thighs.
I'm a mutant and turtle.
That's not you, Rager. Shut the hell up.
That's true.
Oh. All right. What else?
I think it's time for callers.
Callers!
That's a good
shit. Got an hour and a half for callers.
Well, good sir. I don't even know what the hell time you're on.
There's another
thunderstorm.
Game
time. Who?
Game time. If you would like to be in the ChronoCast as a caller or as a constituent, whatever the hell that means, you can call Jamie.
I want to do it this time. He did it
last
time.
He's eating food.
Okay.
Call me.
You can call LittleBalls2477.
Okay.
On Skype. And he will probably not pick up, but he'll add you to the call. It's going to be a first-come, first-served basis unless you're a girl because Rager likes talking to little girls, so you can add them right there.
You don't always necessarily have to pick. All right, while you're doing this, I am going to the little boys' room. I will be back.
I'll do what I want.
Little boys' room? Oh, my God.
This is why ChronoCast is ready.
Did I push Junk's button?
No, he doesn't have a button. He's too old now.
Okay. I thought you guys' button snipped off.
Well, that's what happens when you get married.
Oh, man.
Diction.
What?
There's a girl tomorrow. She wants to get married to you. Yay or nay?
It's just a random girl.
A girl tomorrow that you've been in love with for a year. You marry her or no? Fucking 3 years.
Unlikely instance. Yeah, sure, why not? But
so you're okay
no
with marriage.
Been...
Jesse's girl!
Oh, God, don't start.
God.
I'm okay with marriage. I just don't have anyone I want to marry.
You're
right
okay
now.
With losing 50% of your stuff?
No.
Well, that's what would happen if you flip a quarter and you get the wrong side.
Yeah, but you can always have like a common law marriage where technically you're not married, and if you divorce, then what's yours is yours. You don't have to.
I will do that forever.
That's just like dumb though, because then you're just like I guess you're expecting
exactly
to,
like doesn't it like kind of put like a damper on the actual relationship, like it casts like a hex over it.
Well, yeah. That's for the two people to decide. I don't know.
I feel like they're cast a hex over.
I'd rather have marriage, I guess. I don't know. Whenever the time comes, because it's probably gonna be a long, long while from now.
You had to fix this mic, so we're gonna get another person in here.
Forever alone.
B.
Oh shit! Sorry, don't call calls? Sniper. I screwed up. Add Sniper. My bad.
I'm getting like 10 million calls right now, so a little late for that.
My bad. Someone in the chat told me.
Whoa.
Hey, no lolling allowed. I screwed up.
I lolled. It happened.
It already happened. Shit.
What are you doing this on? I'm just curious. You know, your little.
I already have 53 contact requests.
My little little
display window. What is this on?
Paint.
Is this like paint?
This is paint. I need to work out something better so we can be more professional.
Yep.
Hey. Trying to work on professionalism here.
He is not picking up, so we're getting another person here.
This is unacceptable. Normally, I would have had at least four girls in.
By
Happy
now.
Panda, there we go.
There would have been at least three girls that were underage and one that was possibly 18 by now.
I gotta go downstairs in a bit to get my food out of the oven.
No, there's a bunch of 14-year-olds and then, you know, one just lying that they're 18.
Perfect.
My God. The Happy Panda, welcome to ChronoCast. You're live, I think.
You big wild Thornberry's fan?
Oh my god.
Welcome. Did you just jizz?
I think he just jizzed his pants.
He did. Oh my god.
Jizz in my pants.
maybe it.
What?
You're naked?
Sorry, I'm sorry for being quiet.
it's a bit late here, so I have to be quiet.
Well, not allowed to be quiet.
Are you naked then? Are you naked?
Oh, yes, sorry.
What time is it for you?
Quarter to three.
Are you calling from England, Land?
Ireland.
Ireland.
Oh, you're Irish. You sounded American.
Ireland.
Yeah, I don't have an accent.
It's a good time, Ireland.
Yeah, you do. There you go.
Does he have an accent?
Yeah, you got an Irish accent. It's not a strong one, but you do have an Irish accent.
So you're pretty much insulting his accent. Don't insult our viewers' accents.
What?
So he can't control his accent.
That was an observation. If I was insulting it would be your accent sounds stupid.
Now you're saying his accent.
That was an example of
how stupid his accent was.
All right. Anyways, Happy Panda, do you have any questions for any of us?
Yes, I have a question for all of you. If you had one video game character to live with, who would it be?
Lara Croft.
What was the question?
If you had one video game character to live with for the rest of your life, who would it be?
Ooh. Yeah, I'd go for Lara Croft.
Wait, with the new one or the old one?
They both got good boobs, so either one.
Yeah.
The one with the pointy boobs?
You know, the Katniss one?
The Katniss one?
Yeah, she's like Katniss.
I go with Yuffie from Final Fantasy VII.
Or maybe I go for one of those girls from Dead or Alive.
Yeah, but that's...
They don't speak English.
They don't speak English as well.
Even better. Just get the hell down to business.
That's going to be boring. You'll get bored of that.
I'll teach him English.
Junkyard teaching people English. All right.
Or he could learn Japanese or,
I can learn some Japanese, but they can learn him a little bit English. Ochiwa.
I mean, they're all European characters.
Arigato.
Well, I'm taking Juliet, so you guys can't have her.
It's not Jessica Negri, it's Juliet. You're aware of this, correct?
Well, it looks just like Jessica Negri's, or Negri.
So at least he'll fap happy. That's good to know.
Juliet is awesome.
I'll go with Yuffie from Final Fantasy VII. Not like no one will know who that is.
I always butcher the name and call her Yuffie.
Yeah, Yuffie or Yuffie. I always just call it Yuffie. Like Eris and Tifa.
Tifa.
People call it Tifa.
Oops, my bad. Because I like the name Tifor. Tiffer, I like that name. I'm naming my dog that. I don't even care. My first son's going to be called Johnny McCarter. Sounds like a good American name.
That's a strong name.
Here is right, Johnny McCarter. I'm thinking that would work out well.
For your dog? That's cool.
No, I was thinking like my kid, Johnny McCarter.
Yeah, that's not even name your dog.
It's not too bad.
Why? I want to name my kid, my dog, Johnny McCarter.
And you're like, hey, Johnny McCarter, get over here. Stop barking.
It's too long for a dog.
Fetch.
Johnny McCarter. But, so who are you definitely dating? You definitely going with Juliet, Rager?
Hell yeah, that's not even a question, dude. That's final answer right there.
I guess I'm going with Cortana.
Are they?
Yeah, I guess so. In her human form.
What's Yutark taking?
Yuffie from Final Fantasy VII.
Jen, who are you taking?
I don't know.
Girl? You a girl?
I'm thinking Nathan.
You a girl.
Or, like, Uncharted.
Come on, do a girl!
No.
So you're going to pick Guitar Master?
No. God, no.
He looks just like that guy.
Nathan Fillion?
Yeah.
Essentially the same guy. That's your real life... That's the real life counterpart, Nathan Fillion.
Of who?
You know who that is?
Yeah.
Firefly main character.
Yes.
Yeah.
Yes.
The most amazing man on the face of the planet.
Samus from the Metroid series. Oh, that's a good one.
Samus?
Yeah, but you can't see your goods while you're playing the game.
Doesn't matter. You can imagine.
You got that
there.
Big bodysuit on. You can't see anything.
So what? I pick Master Chief.
Pick Master Chief? You fucking...
Bro, you protect me.
What if Master Chief is a girl or like a girl in secret?
Well, it's John.
John could be a girl's name.
No, it's not. John's never a girl's name. You have Joanna as a girl's name. John. Hey, John. Hey. You know, it doesn't work out like that.
I'd be like, hey, John.
Hey. Never works out like that. But, holy shit, who's typing?
Me?
Damn it, Dixon. You need that stealth keyboard.
Yeah, this is what you sound like.
Is it really still that loud? God damn it.
You got a mechanical keyboard?
No, I don't.
I thought you
were... people get those mechanical keyboards. They just make a bunch of noise.
Yeah, but they feel so good.
Oh.
Feels so good.
My
keyboard's all messed up.
All right, Panda, do you see anything else for us?
Are you guys familiar with the Hunger Games?
The what?
Hunger Games?
Are you familiar with the Hunger Games?
Never heard of it.
We're playing it. We sound like idiots. Like,
if you were in it, what would your weapon of choice?
I would take a copy of Battle Royale to prove everyone they're full of shit.
I would take a copy of the Bible to convince people that everyone should hold hands and get together. Maybe sing Kumbaya.
I've seen Rambo 4, and that's never going to happen.
Oh. Yeah.
What weapon?
Rambo 4, you can't
pick?
Mess with those people. There's no talking to them.
No just, talking.
It's just they kill you or you kill them. That's about it.
Yeah, but the Bible can stop bullets.
It can.
Major, have you ever seen a movie that doesn't have guns in it?
The Notebook. Wait, no, that has guns in it. Damn it.
Notebook had guns in it?
No, it doesn't.
Yeah, it had there's a war in it, wasn't there?
Oh, yeah, you're right. Never mind. Yeah, holy shit, Rager knows more about Notebook than I do.
I have a copy of Notebook. This is I have all man movies, but I got the Notebook is the only one I have.
Well, that's good. Know. Like when you invite a girl over, she's like, oh, you want to watch a movie?
It's
yeah.
Strategy.
Let's watch the Notebook.
You want to know something, though? That would never work. At least on someone like me, like watching the Notebook together, like as like a date thing, would not do anything. It wouldn't work.
No, you need at least one lady DVD or whatever.
No, Jurassic Park would suffice.
Oh
yeah,
yeah. Jurassic Park is a good one.
Well, that could scare the girl over to you. But...
Jurassic Park doesn't scare anyone unless you're a girl. Oops.
I knew a kid in my high school that peed his pants at the Jurassic Park at the T-Rex scene.
How old is he?
Wow.
Yeah, well, he's pretty young, so.
Well, oh well.
I don't know. Scary games would, or I mean, not scary games. Scary movies would kind of work if you're like, you know, just watching like a movie with a girl or whatever, because that would work, you know, she'd cuddle up to you because she's scared, that
exactly.
Kind of thing. But like lovey-dovey romantic shitty movies would not work at all.
Oh, so how to lose a guy in 10 days is not gonna work out.
It's not gonna work.
Okay. Yeah, anyone go watch Ring 2 or something?
No, fuck off.
Anything with Matthew McConaughey is out of question.
Ring 2 I don't like Matthew McConaughey, so.
Well, you heard it here first, guys.
Hey,
girls do
hey,
not like
on.
Matthew McConaughey.
Hold on. Days
at least I don't.
Days and confused.
Is it you don't like server guys? He's like a big surfer, dude.
Nah, I don't care.
Well, okay, thank you for the call, Happy Panda.
Thank you! Have a good night.
Bye, Panda.
Bye.
You too.
Bye. I killed him.
All right, Jesse's girl's ready now.
Jesse's girl is a guy. Call.
Jesse's girl!
How's it going on?
Jesse. Isn't there a song about that?
Stacy's
yes.
Mom.
Jesse's mom.
No, Stacy's mom.
Going on.
Stacy's mom.
Jesse's mom.
No, Stacey's you're wrong, Rachel.
Mom has got it going on. I like it.
You ever do with Stacy?
I've done a friend's mom before. I did.
Jesse, is your
mom
Stacy?
That's a lie. That's a damn lie, Chuck.
Okay, let's move on.
I don't know here.
So is your mom Stacy, Jesse?
What?
What's your mom's name?
Krista.
Damn it.
But wait, you say Marissa?
No, Krista.
Krista?
Krista's
Krista
mom.
Explains it all. That's Carissa. Oops. So, Jesse, welcome to the ChronoCast. How
nice.
Are you doing?
Well, I'd rather be in the Power Hour.
Oh.
Whoa.
Well.
What the hell's that?
So is this a chilled fan here?
Yep.
What do you want me to do, Jesse?
He's a fanboy.
This is ChronoCast.
Well, my question is to Children Diction.
Okay.
I'm going to take a pee break since he doesn't care about me.
You may be there a while, then, Major.
I hate you!
Don't follow him on Twitter, too. It really sets him off.
Okay, so my question is, when are you guys going to continue Derpcraft?
Derpcraft, that will hopefully continue whenever Smarty puts in his hard drive and whenever I can get the server working again.
Oh.
Yeah. I just kind of jump in whenever I'm drunk.
Which is usually every night.
Always. Yeah.
But no, we'll do it again. It's just we have to actually, everyone has to be there. It's rough getting everyone involved. I mean, when you think about this group right now, there's only one night that everyone can actually do everything on, and it's a Monday,
right.
So... It's rough when there's a lot of people.
Or Tuesday.
Actually, my
or
favorite.
Tuesday.
I can't do anything on Tuesdays.
My
I help the elderly on
fire.
Tuesdays.
Fucking
my favorite fire. Episodes were when Rio was lagging.
Those were good because Rio didn't know what the hell she was doing. Poor person. Did you realize I buried her while she was getting out of there?
Yeah.
I felt bad after thinking about it.
You don't.
I did. A little bit.
No. I was watching your screen, not anyone else's, because I'm a fan of you, not anyone else.
Wow, okay, why are you asking me around? Oh, that's gonna
All right.
Well, Jesse, thank you for the call.
Thank you for answering.
It's good. You, next time you should call on Sundays then, and we'll talk on Sundays.
Okay, well, I might not be up because my parents are strict about going to sleep.
Well, kudos to your parents. Have a good night, Jesse.
Good night.
Take care.
Good night. Bye-bye.
He sounded really thrilled. Jesse was a little lackluster.
He sounded thrilled.
He didn't sound thrilled at all.
It's a chill fan, you know?
Oh. Yeah. They're all beat down and they don't care about life anymore, you know? They're chilled fans.
They're on the verge of death. It's suicide. That's why they're chilled fans.
Well, might as well just decide if I should end it or not.
Oh, God. God, Davey's gone already?
This video will depend on the future of my life.
Yeah, I'd probably talk about suicide that video. Well, it must be a signal.
So how'd that go?
It went good. Went good. He was very happy to talk to me, and he was very glad you left because you were running the call. And ultimately, it was good. It was a good caller.
How did we get Ryan in here?
Cool. Ryan. Sounds like a good old Irish name. Ryan.
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 Is this the Ryan from Saving Private Ryan?
Ryan.
Yep.
Ryan.
Is that Ryan? That exact Ryan.
Tom Hanks got to save him.
Is Ryan in the call?
Ryan.
Bueller.
My thing is glitching, so I don't know when he picks up, so I'm going to rely on other people.
You can hear it. He just picked up.
Oh, okay. Ryan.
Hello?
Ryan.
Hello?
What's up? Oh, sup?
Hey, welcome to the podcast.
Hi.
Thanks.
How are you today?
Yeah, how are you?
I have a question for you all.
Cool.
Oh.
I'm fine.
Oh, good.
So,
what's your question?
That was a good question.
I have a question.
Okay, cool. How are you doing?
I'm fine.
So, do you have a question?
What's the scariest game you all ever played?
Good time joke.
Yeah.
Scariest game? Max Payne 1.
Yeah.
What?
Max Payne 1.
That wasn't scary. Are you
kidding me? That's not even a scary game.
Junk's a father.
When the kids started screaming, it freaked me out, so.
And that beginning scene is, if you're a parent, that beginning scene is pretty horrifying, I gotta say.
And there's that one scene on Homefront at the beginning where that, like, family gets killed in front of the kids' eyes. Do you remember that?
I never
played Homefront single player? Oh. Well, this is, like, a really, like, traumatic scene. Like, you're playing the game and, like, what is it? You're in this bus because the Koreans are getting all the Americans out. And you see just, like, these two, like, I'm guessing, like, mother and father just get, like, executed in front of a kid. Like, their kid. And it's pretty traumatic.
Were you traumatized?
No.
Well, that's
not traumatic. But I was like, oh, wow, that was... I've not seen anything like that before.
Wow, if I was susceptible to this kind of trauma, I'd be traumatized right now.
But no, I was just, like, putting the relation to Max Payne. It's a similar kind
of
thing.
No, I understand.
It's the opposite way.
Totally get that. I don't play horror games because I'm a girl.
You gotta play that SCP downstairs game.
That's what people are telling me, but my problem.
And not even
that,
like
that's
good.
That's what I'm gonna pick right there because that scared the fuck out of me when I got to the hallway level or where you're just going through the hallways and shit and you just, you know, it's just
same
you're
thing,
doing
like,
it for like 10 minutes and right around the 10 minute or 12 minute mark, you know, it starts popping out and just random stuff happens and it's just scary as hell. You never know when it's gonna happen.
I remember when you were playing that and you're talking about how manly you are and how you're not going to get scared and that kind of thing, but you screamed like a little bitch, so. I don't think I've ever really played like any scary game, so.
Resident Evil 2 or Silent Hill 1, probably the scariest games I've ever played.
Is that because you were a little kid or because they were legitimately scary looking back?
No, yeah. I was, I probably played them like a couple years after they came out.
Okay.
But, like, I was still about, like, 13, 12 or something, so they were pretty fucking scary.
I don't play horror games, because horror games don't work well for me. Because I don't play games to be scared, because I don't think I enjoy them that way.
Play SCP and you'll change your mind.
Well, I don't want to be scared. Why do I want to be scared?
No, it's just fun.
You're not going to be scared. You're going to be scared shitless.
No. Glad you want to be happy.
Because I panic then, and panic leads to bad things.
Or get a bedpan ready.
Right?
I'm bedpan.
Probably would happen. What's your scariest game, Ryan?
It's a Flash game, actually. It's called The House.
That game wasn't scary. I played that with Smarty.
It's called you a pussy, dude.
Yeah, bro. Wasn't even that scary, man.
It's called you out.
No, that's... Other than that, I don't know.
I don't really like horror games.
Okay. Doesn't like horror games. Ask a horror game question.
I had to ask a question.
Well, you didn't have to call, Ryan. But we're glad you did.
It's like a backhanded
passive aggressive man.
Yeah, shit.
So, does anyone else have any horror game comments, critiques? Comments again?
I mean, Silent Hill is still like the scariest game ever made.
Uh-huh.
Out of that, that game flipped me.
Didn't they do a HD remake of Silent Hill?
Did they?
I don't know. Was it that or was it Resident Evil? I can't remember which one it was.
Resident Evil, they did it HD on the GameCube.
Yeah.
Silent Hill just did a remake, though, recently. I think it came out like 2 months ago.
Dead Space isn't... Someone said in the chat Dead Space 3. Dead Space isn't really a scary game. It's more gory as fuck.
It's jump scary, but it's not like... It keeps you on edge. It's tense, but I wouldn't call it scary.
I mean, when I played the first one, when it came out, I got it like a week after it came out, and I had to play with a friend. Oh, he wanted to watch, and I didn't have a headset back then. I didn't think using a headset was like a good thing. I thought it was like, I've got like 5.1 surround sound speakers, why the fuck would I want to use a headset? But yeah, we played, he watched and I played, and it was fucking, he made it scary for me because he kept like freaking out every like little thing. So I guess that's another thing. And like when I played Amnesia for the first time, like I played it, and then like shortly after I started making YouTube videos, and that was like the first thing I did. But I played it, and when I first got it, I watched a couple videos on it, and my friend, my housemates, I had like two out of five housemates in the house at the time, and it was night, and I was like, look, I've seen, I showed them like a couple videos of like people getting scared, reactions and stuff.
And two I was girls, like, one cup. That was scary. Sorry.
Yeah. Okay. Yeah.
Sorry. No. Sorry. I didn't mean to.
And I said like, look, I'm gonna keep my door open. I'm gonna turn the lights off. I'm gonna put my headset on, and like, switch out the landing lights. And if you like want to come in at any time and just like try and scare the fuck out of me, feel free to do so. Because I wanted to like get as scared as possible.
Oh,
and like,
God, I would.
I was playing for like an hour, and because I wanted to see how like. How terrified I could get, and like the thought of them coming in and scaring me was scary enough, and then knowing that like no they didn't forget. I thought they did, because like an hour and a bit had gone by and I'm still playing, and like I got to like this part where you're in like this like cellar or something, or it was after the water like monster scene, and I just like I felt like something. I didn't like feel like a breeze or anything, or anything.
Just something like
yeah. I was like, I wonder if they're there now. Like, oh, and God. I looked to the right, like on my right shoulder, and all I could see was my bed, and like my bed was lit up, and then I turned back, and no one was there. And then in the corner of my left eye, I could just see a face, and I looked, and it was my housemate. Like he's just like smiling like scarily, like a really scary face, but it was just. Dimly lit by the monitors, like, light, scared the shit. I literally, like, I've never been more scared in my life, but it was so worth it because, like, the adrenaline after it was so fun. And, yeah, that's why I like scary games, because, like, the adrenaline is fun.
That, I guess,
and because you make funny faces.
Yeah, but don't you feel like what happens? There's going to be that one time you're playing a scary game, and actually someone does break into your house and shit goes down. I know the minute I do that, that's what's going to happen, and I can't live with that.
I'll probably react like, oh my god, that's, oh god. What the fuck was
and
that?
And then knives are thrown. Yeah, I mean, I don't want that shit going on.
Like, someone's breaking in your house right now.
I know.
Like, that's why I can't probably do that. Get really afraid, like, and then like think it was like my housemate Todd just like joking around, and then actually realize, wait, no, it wasn't. And then be even more afraid.
Yeah, but you gotta live with the good times too, man.
So exactly. Do you live in like the city area or what?
I'm close. I do. It's pretty close.
So there's lots of like burglars and stuff around there.
No, I'm in a good neighborhood for the most part, but like the town over, not too good. Kind of.
I live right next to the shit area, so I'm on like the border. Like I'm in the nice area, but just like 10-minute walk away is just like knives and Polish gangs and Russian gangs and stuff.
All of the gangs.
Are
you playing music?
No.
Yeah, you are.
That's what the chat says.
The chat doesn't know what's going on. The chat's crazy.
Chat said that 80s music.
People, they don't even know what 80s music is, but they went around for the 80s. How can I know the 80s music? God.
You don't know that. I saw someone saying that they were 27.
That's creepy. Not because it's old. I mean, just because, you know, they're 27, and 27 is a weird number. I love you. Oh, so Ryan, Ryan.
What? Yeah, what? I'm still here.
You have to leave, Ryan.
Okay.
Bye, Ryan.
Bye.
Bye, Ryan.
Get another caller in, you Tork. We got to keep it going along.
Tork.
Rage's doing it. Rage's doing
it. Oh, I'm sorry.
Get a girl. Get a girl, Rage.
You want a girl? This person's going to be pissed.
Hey, why did you just delete them?
Because you Tork, they want a girl in here.
I get what I want.
I don't think they have a girl.
Well.
It's Cody.
Cody?
Yeah,
it's definitely a little 12-year-old boy.
Are you sure?
That's even perfect.
You say he's a big fan of CoronaCast, so you better get in here. I add the legit people.
Hello.
Hey, welcome to CoronaCast.
Hello. I told you.
Hey, wow, I'm surprised I got on.
We were told you're a big fan of CoronaCast.
Have you seen every episode?
Well, I just randomly decided to add Rager.
We call him Ranger.
Ranger. Ranger hero.
Sorry.
I feel like Ranger I work at like some forest campground.
He's working on a new name anyway, so it's fine.
He's a Power Ranger.
Wow.
Well, did you were saying it earlier. Shut up.
Which Power Ranger would you be?
Go, Power Ranger.
He'd be the white one.
Yeah, he would be.
Your Tork would be the pink one, so shut the fuck up.
I like that pink. I have like a salmon pink shirt, actually. They're really nice.
Salmon pink shirt.
Huh.
It's not something you want to admit, you Tork.
There's nothing wrong with having a salmon pink shirt. It's a really
it's
nice
salmon.
Color.
Salmon.
Yeah.
Yeah, but salmon pink is like a good color.
It's a good, no, for a shirt with a nice tie and with a suit.
I have a salmon pink, a button shirt.
Ooh.
Yeah, it looks good. With the
don't, no, no.
Don't knock it, try it.
I don't care what the woman says, it's all about the man looking good.
Exactly.
And if he thinks he looks good.
A power
but
tie
what if, what
well?
If all girls don't? What if all girls didn't think it looked good?
Doesn't
though?
Matter.
I didn't buy it to impress the women, Jan. I bought it to impress myself.
Exactly.
When I look down, look at that tie.
Dress for success, man.
Oh, that's funny.
Stupid ducks in their ties.
What?
What? So did you have a question or you want to talk about something? Okay, Monkey.
Well, real quick about the Power Rangers. Funny story is I actually had a teacher that used to be a Power Ranger, like in the real show.
That's not
what?
Funny.
What?
Cool.
Which one? Wait, which one?
He was the red one, I think.
Oh, no one
oh
liked him.
Oh my god, I remember
that was a badass one.
Oh, I guess people did like him.
Yeah.
I was more of a Green Ranger kind of guy. The green and yellow looked cool.
The Power Rangers confused me, like, the entire show. Like, I'd watch it when I was younger, and I'd be like, what the fuck is this?
Well, I was told
I didn't
as,
get it.
As a rumor that they were the, whatchamacallit, the Europeans were the guys when they took off the masks, but they had smaller people from Asia play the actual stunts. That's what I was always told.
It was makes sense. Yeah, you can like tell that sort of Japan. Movement on them.
I was just, that's true. What I was told.
Yeah.
I don't know if these were rumors or if they were the truth. Wait, so was your guy, was he a small Asian man?
No, he was actually, like, really... He was probably, like, 6'5".
So how the hell did he go from 6'5" to small... Oh, well. I'll never know. Movie magic, I guess. So did you want to talk about something else?
Anyways, it's for, like, everyone here. If you could live your life like any video game, what video game would it be?
Gosh, we've had that question.
You have?
I don't think, like, exactly like that. Kind of thing. So if you were in like a certain video game world,
yeah, like your for example, like DayZ or something like that.
Oh no, that's bad.
You'd
glitch out every single time. It's not fun.
That's a good question.
The Sims. Mm-hmm. I'd pick The Sims.
Oh,
I have a good time in The Sims. Me,
you
Molly,
destroy
Kate.
People.
I guess that's a pretty good one though, because it does have all like the entities,
life.
Like you know, like a bathroom, a kitchen, that kind of stuff. So you never starve. Because if you think of something like. I don't know, like...
Put me in the late-night expansion.
Like a Mario game or something like that. Like, you'd starve to death.
And
if
you don't
you
shit
were...
anywhere, and, like, Bowser's trying
I'd
to kill you.
Realm
you
the
you
Mad
just
God.
Shit in the corner.
Realm the Mad God.
Yeah, you
yeah,
would,
Victoria.
That's the shittiest game ever. That's why you pick it.
Just so he doesn't have to deal with Rager ever again.
That's the one place I know in this world that I can be free of Rager.
I don't know how anyone... You're gonna be, like, forever
like,
alone in that
have...
game.
No,
you're the power
no,
of the
it's
internet.
It's not just me out there, it's everyone.
No, we have the internet.
Sucks.
Me and Chilled and the internet would go. It'd be great. It'd be glorious.
It would be glorious. We've killed many things.
Yeah, we have. I guess you guys would never be lonely. You'd have the internet on your side.
Exactly.
Yeah. And they'd give us free shit. You need they'd the best weapon in the game.
You need a bathroom. They give you everything.
Yeah, and rape.
They give you rape sometimes when you're not paying attention.
Yeah, don't you want a little rape with your breakfast? Right,
cover up your holes.
Diction, what about you? Where are you living?
What was the question? What?
Video game world you have to live in for the rest of your life. No continues.
Skyrim, bro.
Yeah, Skyrim.
You can't take my answer.
Oh, I didn't know you spoke because I don't listen to you.
Oh, okay.
That was Utoric speaking, not Rager.
Fine, Morrowind. Oh. What does it matter? It's all Tamriel.
That's true. That's true.
Morrowind has the better music, in my opinion.
Junk, where the hell are you living?
You know, I've been trying to figure that out. I don't know. If I drove better, I'd probably go Paradise Burnout. You know, just drive and have some cool, hit some jumps and shit like that. Just something different.
Junk said and that. Shit like that? I don't think I've ever heard Junk say that.
Thank God for me.
It's new.
Other than that, I don't know.
Ooh, Red Dead
I don't
Redemption.
Remember what that answer was the last time because we had this question before and I didn't remember what my answer was then. So it's
someone
obviously
said Red Dead.
I'm gonna say for me it's Saints Row 3.
Really?
Yeah.
I'd go Saints Row 1. At least the world was normal.
Oh, Saints Row 3, man. That's fun.
The world's fucked up.
You can do whatever you want. You can do whatever you want.
Yeah, that's what the commercial said. But in reality,
and you can wear it. You can slap people with dildos and shit.
Until you're the one getting
you can't even
right.
buy food in that game. I would say Saints Row 2, if anything.
More customization options.
Yeah, exactly.
Cares about food.
Well, if you're living the real world, maybe you want food.
Well, if there's a game that has no food, you don't have to worry about food. I'm all for that.
You'd miss food, like.
No, but if it was like I don't know, you're a human being being put in a world without like food and stuff. You still need to like need food and that kind of thing still to survive, right?
I would think so.
I love food. Food and sleep.
Farming simulator.
I think I'll switch my answer to Red Dead because you can, you know, kill your own animals and that kind of thing and stuff.
That's fucked up.
And it would be sweet because you'd like ride a horsey around.
I'm picking
everywhere.
The ship then and the Sims together. Live on both those. Or
I'm gonna be
Terrace
Angry
Town.
Birds. Angry Birds. Yeah.
Angry Birds.
Jan, you do realize there's no deodorant or anything back in those days in Red Dead Redemption.
So your game doesn't have enough detail to have.
People smell like complete shit.
Yeah, but whatever the hell you chose, because I forgot, doesn't have so much detail that people have to use deodorant.
I'm going Leisure Suit Larry.
Bathing soap.
Leisure Suit Larry. That's
at least like if you pick like Sims or whatever, you get a shower.
That's true.
Mm-hmm.
And you can have children, which I don't know
why. And a pool. You can have a pool.
That is true. So Okiyama Shatsu, where the hell are you living?
Children, scary. Oh, well, my username's pronounced Okamiyasha.
So Okiyama Hashu, where are you living?
I live in California.
No.
In the game.
In the game. I would probably live in Minecraft because you go against logic because you can break a tree with your hand.
Well, you can if you're strong. Chuck Norris did.
I can do it.
Oh. Yeah, that's probably where I would live.
But I just had to use one finger to break it down.
Oh boy, here we go again.
Okay, a tree is not like a sapling, okay?
All you gotta do is flick it. Flick it really
not
fast.
Not a dandelion, man.
That's what she said.
I thought you were pronouncing his name.
Continue.
So, definitely continue? Minecraft?
Yeah, that's what I would choose personally.
That's good.
Well, you don't go to the bathroom at all in that.
Dig a hole and pop a squat.
You can make a bathroom. Maybe.
Yeah, but you don't use it.
So
you can't make make a toilet or anything.
While you eat food.
Can you imagine a world where you just don't have to use the bathroom? That'd be weird.
I like pooping. That'd be awesome.
Yeah, I do too. It's like a relaxation time. You get to think about the world when you shit. No one bothers you. Sometimes.
I feel like it's such a hassle like to go up and go to the bathroom at all. Like even if just for like a piss, because you have to. Like, say if you're just sitting somewhere and
ungrateful.
You're comfortable, and then you have to get up and go take a piss. It's so annoying.
Yeah, but then you just extend it into a shit, and then you get like some relaxation time.
Oh, God.
Telling you, it works like that.
Yeah, but if I'm doing something like playing a game, for instance,
then
I don't want to have to.
Button,
I don't.
Woman.
Yeah, but I don't want to have to keep getting up like.
Well,
and
do you have a
piss.
Problem where you have to get up every 10 minutes?
Well, yeah, I drink a lot of iced tea and water and that kind of stuff. I'm like an old person. I have to take a piss every 20 minutes sometimes.
All what's right, that then. Commercial? Like, you know, that can help your bladder. I don't know. Like, they have it. Like, are you missing out on your life? Is your bladder controlling everything? I've seen those commercials, Dan. We can help you.
I know.
I have seen those, actually.
And then they wake up in the middle of the night.
That's all BS. That stuff doesn't even work.
It's like the kiddie. The guy goes to his son's recital, and he misses the entire thing. I don't know why the son's doing a recital, but, you know, it happens like that nowadays. And he just misses it because his bladder just explodes. We can help
you. Do you have problems with your bladder?
No, Rager. But I.
No, Rager, because he.
Why would I have problems with my bladder?
What do you know about this?
You know about the.
I just know the marketing schemes. I know how stuff works nowadays.
Yeah, but.
Oh, okay.
What if it?
They're just trying to get your money.
Yeah, but what if it?
Can I come to you for advice?
Yeah. They have all these vitamins now. It's like, oh, take this multivitamin pill, and it gives you all the vitamins that you need, and half that shit doesn't even fucking matter.
What annoys me about the vitamins, you have the once a day tablets, and on the back it says you should have two a day. It really confuses me.
Some of that shit's bullshit, and you're just wasting money on vitamins that aren't even there.
Well, if you were Norm and Jaden of the FBI, you'd understand. You'd understand. It's the FBI.
There you go.
Akimayashu, do you have anything else? Otherwise, we're going to kill you horribly.
Akimayashu!
Anyway, I'll ask one more. If you could create, like, your own world and, like, nothing applied, you could create it however, what world would you create?
I'd create our world.
A world of peace and harmony and a lot of sex and boobs.
God damn it,
man. It's like what we are living in right now.
Exactly.
So.
I like what we have now. But with less just crazy
without,
people.
Maybe without you, Torque.
Yeah.
No Rama Mad God either.
That's it. You've gone too far. Anyone else?
Mars. Okay.
Mars is. Thank you for the call, Okamayashu.
Okamayashu! No
John, what the fuck, John?
It's pouring rain outside, and it's thundering a lot, and I don't like this.
Yeah, Commander Shepard coming in here.
Commander Shepard.
Gotta talk about the Mass Effect 3 ending.
He could run again? Like a Krogan, he could fight like a Shepard, but he'll never be better than Commander. I fucked everything up. Goddamn. You could fight like a Krogan, you could run like a Leopard, but you'll never be better than Commander Shepard. And, okay, next caller.
That was beautiful.
What the fuck?
Next caller. Next caller.
We got a girl coming in.
Hello. Next caller.
Oh, girl.
Hmm.
You have 2 seconds to answer, my
God.
All right,
Junkyard, you open up with this one. You know, you got this, Junk.
Hey, wait.
Are they in?
Cole failed.
We'll try again.
Sir.
Try again.
Sir.
Try again.
Try again.
Try again.
She's dead to me. Next caller.
I'm a girl.
Next victim.
Wake up, age.
Good. Junk, you can open up with this one now.
I'm a girl?
Yes, Junk, would you take it away?
Oh my God.
I'm a girl?
Hey, how's it going?
Hey, you are definitely not a girl, but hey, everybody, it's Junkyard here. We got I'm a girl that's not a girl in the room. Where are you calling from?
I'm a girl.
Lies and slander.
More lies and slander.
I love you,
this guy's
Jill.
Full of lies.
I'm not lying. You lie more. That isn't you.
We should probably.
Ranger, that isn't you.
You don't even know what you're talking about.
That's all right,
take this guy. Get one of those straight jackets. Get him out of here.
No.
Leave your girl. That's all that matters.
Oh, God. No, you're not a girl. Ranger, you're failing here.
I like this guy right here.
Oh, I spoke to him yesterday.
Yeah, he called you a ball master for me, so we got to talk to him.
Yeah, he was an asshole. But I spoke to him yesterday. I was actually hooking up with another girl called Christina, because I thought it was cool, Christian and Christina. God. So it's like, hey, Christina, here's Christian. Christina, me and Christian like, yeah, he's like benching 150, you know, nowadays. It was pretty cool. We were. Christian, hey, how's Christina doing? Don't let me down, man.
I don't know. I haven't talked to her.
I thought you guys hooked up. What the fuck?
I was trying to help.
She had a boyfriend.
Oh. That doesn't matter.
But you can be her friend with benefits.
Exactly. Like when she breaks up, you know, you can be there, you know, for the shoulder to cry on and eventually have sex with. Works every time.
How do you even know that?
So, I don't even know. I've been that guy. Trust me, Rager. I've been there.
All right. So, you got any questions?
Been there, done that.
Yes.
Yeah. What's the most fun you guys ever had, like, recording a video?
Oh. I don't have fun. I don't believe in
fun.
Wait,
what was the question? I didn't hear that.
What's the most fun you guys have ever had recording a video?
I think mine is Ghostbusters with Yutorg, surprisingly.
Those are funny.
I don't know.
I think my trailer dubs are my favorite things to do.
But. You know, probably mine is, I'd have to say, with Chilled when we did, whatchamacallit? What the hell is the game?
Well, obviously, we didn't have that good of a time, Junk.
What was the hell of the game we played that I'm drawing a blank on? The puzzle game that we did. Portal.
Good, you had a good time. I had a horrible time.
Well, I know you were freaking all anal, but I was laughing my ass off.
You literally, Junk, you were not a help at all. These puzzles I had to figure out.
I didn't lose any sleep over it.
I lost so much sleep.
You did, not me.
I know. You're a bad puzzle maker. You are the worst puzzle maker ever.
But I had fun, so that's all that matters.
Yeah, I guess so.
Wasn't there a couple times where Junk actually figured out the puzzle and you couldn't?
Once. One time.
That's all that matters.
That is all that matters, because he never let it down afterwards.
I did.
Well, good for him.
Well, bad for him.
He shouldn't let it down.
I damn him again. Christian, you have fun playing video games?
Yes.
What's the most fun moment you had playing a video game? You can sound excited if you want. You're allowed to.
I
think he's overwhelmed.
It had to have been something like that I played growing up on the PS2.
PS2? PS2? Just everything?
Well, damn it, I don't know.
Okay, then.
All right. Well, thank you for the call, Christian.
Hey, wait a minute, Chilled. I have something to tell you.
You talked to me yesterday.
Yeah, I know, but this is quick. I'm the one who made that cocksucker 9000 on Twitter.
Well, there was like three of you guys.
actually, I made the one that has the two at the end. And apparently the first one was some guy in Russia, because I looked it up and it was like all in like Russian.
So it's just
kind of sounds a little bit like Smarty too.
Yeah, you put Smarty's picture on there.
I put Smarty's picture there because it was cocksucker 9000. I thought it was fitting.
Was that 9000 cocks, or is it just the fact that that's his nickname, the 9000 part?
It's 9000 cocks.
Okay, that's good. That's a lot.
Did he fix his hard drive, by the way?
He's working on it. Working on it.
He's still
he's working on it. It's a work in progress. It's a 2-week hard drive install. It takes time. Thank you for the call, Christian. We gotta get some other callers. Have yourself a lovely night.
You too.
Take care. Funny. Bro, it's a 2-week project. Don't give him shit, man. It's 2 weeks.
Okay. Says right out of the box. It'll take you 2 weeks to install a new hard drive.
You thought it was a quick installation? You didn't read the box?
You thought you were going on vacation?
Hey, this guy has got a duck for an avatar.
His name is Mallard, kind of.
He says he's been trying to get in for a while, so be nice to him.
Okay. Danny, what the fuck you want?
Hi.
Oh, he's kind of nice. And
hi. Sounds like something I'd say.
Do you like ducks?
Yeah.
Do you like to play duck hunt?
At times.
I love duck hunt.
I do it in real life.
You're dead to me.
Torque, you're dead to me too, ever since you started playing Realm of Mad God.
Who are you?
I only know people I follow on Twitter, sorry, Rager.
Alright, so Danny, you got any questions for any of us?
Or anything you want to talk about in general?
Yeah.
Have you guys ever been, like, neglected? By your parents, I mean?
This is weird.
I don't feel comfortable. Your dad was mean to you, wasn't he?
Yeah, well, there was belts involved sometimes, but that was my grandfather.
you said you were scared of him.
Yeah, well, obviously you're supposed to be scared of your father.
Yeah, I'm afraid of my dad.
It's just a very, an imposing figure of someone, and it's Italian too, so you got the loud, the hand motions, just like, it's just, you get a little, so it's not, we wouldn't really call it neglect, it's just you're supposed to strike a fear. As Junkyard being a father, he would agree with that, right?
Well, yeah, I mean,
you have to be afraid.
You want... A little bit of fear, obviously, in your kids, so they freaking know what the hell they're doing and they do it right.
Yeah,
I mean, but but you don't want to. There's a level there.
I would just like to be accepted sometimes too.
Yeah, that's all it comes in.
Yeah.
So, that's about it.
Are you neglected at home? Is this something you want to talk about in private?
Oh, no.
Okay. Just thought it was a weird question.
Yeah, my dad doesn't scare me, because if he gets angry, just wave something funny in front of his face, and just like that, he did this total turnaround. It's funny. It's like a teddy bear. It's funny.
I'm a teddy bear.
If your Pokemon's stomach does, you go, woohoo.
Eventually, my sister actually does that. And then after a little while, he gets a little bit angry and annoyed, and then we just leave him alone.
Well, I think we should move on to a different caller, one with more uplifting tones and hopefully an upbeat attitude.
Wait. Wait, chill. Chill, no.
All right, you can speak.
Oh, I thought you were going to say something.
You guys aren't responding. I'm confused.
Bye, Danny.
Oh my god.
What the hell was that?
I don't know.
That's funny. What did he say?
Oh my god.
I don't know.
He thought you were going to kick him like right away, so he just kept on talking and you didn't.
That kind of awkward because you didn't take him.
If you get called in, let's talk about happy things sometimes. Rager,
let's talk to a girl here.
Okay.
Holly Dolly.
Do you hear that? Can you hear that? That is so fucking loud.
What?
What?
Thunder.
I hear white noise.
Oh.
From someone.
I hear white noise too.
Who's called?
That's probably the thunder.
Yeah. No, tap the mic, Jen. It's not you.
Holly, hi, can you tap your mic?
Hi! Hi, Holly!
Hi, Holly.
Hi.
Holly, woo!
There you go, it's gone. Sweet. No, now it's back.
No, it's Holly's mic.
I'm closing my window. Sorry. Okay.
Jan, stop screwing things up.
Jan, you're breaking the stream!
I'm sorry, but it's really, really hot. Can you guys hear me? And it's raining and it's thunder.
Yeah, we can hear you.
Okay. Kind of wondered.
So what's going on?
Hi, Holly. Where are you calling from and how old are you?
Can you hear us?
I scared away.
I think she lost connection.
Fucking
wait! Hold on.
Dude, it just drives women away.
You gotta mute the stream.
Fuck you. I hate you.
I did mute the stream.
Don't cross the streams!
Can you guys hear me now?
Yes, I can hear you. Can you hear us?
Okay. Yes, I can hear you.
Where are you calling from and stuff? And all that good
Oregon.
Shit.
Oregon. I am calling from Oregon.
That is a hub.
There's nothing in Oregon. You're right on what, top do you, what do you do in Oregon?
Pretty much nothing in Oregon.
Yeah, why do you live there?
There's nothing in Oregon.
So when you get older again, stay there or gonna move out?
I wanna move so bad.
Are you gonna go to California?
No, I don't. Right, well,
go live in Hollywood? Be a big star?
No, not at all. Kinda wanna move to Colorado.
I live in Colorado.
You don't wanna
Colorado
go there.
Sounds amazing.
Rocky Mountain High, Colorado.
Holly, how old are you?
18.
Okay.
And Torch has lost all interest.
Torch, you're such a creeper, dude. Get the hell out of here.
Well, that's a normal question. How old are you?
It is a normal question.
Yeah, you didn't ask
it
any
is a normal
of the guys.
Question. Thank you, Holly.
You didn't ask any
it's
of
like
the
guys. It's like saying ASL. Get the hell out of here.
No, it's not. It's not saying age, sex, and location. That's
you already asked her where she was calling from, then you asked her age. And you
That's a question we ask everyone.
We already know who she is. So
what? What if this is getting to know someone? That's what you do.
That's the first thing pedos say in chat.
Do you have experience with pedos in chats?
I believe he
no.
does.
Because I don't, so please inform me.
Oh my god.
Never had that experience.
Anyways, Holly, do you got any questions for any of us?
Yeah, all of you.
Wait.
What has been your favorite childhood movie?
Pedos in chat 2.0.
All right.
Childhood movie.
Doesn't count, chill. Say your favorite one.
The Sandlot.
There we go.
Sandlot's good.
Sandlot's really good.
Sandlot's
amazing. It's not good, it's amazing.
Forever.
Well, when I was 6, I used to watch all of The Land Before Times like over and over again for some stupid reason. I don't know why. But I'd have to go with Lion King.
The Lion King.
I
love The Lion.
I was going to say Army of Darkness, but I already said it before because I think we had this question
favorite
before.
Favorite childhood movie?
So I'm going to say Liar Liar because I liked that movie as a kid.
Yeah, no, The Breakfast Club.
Blank Check was good too.
Ooh, Toy Story is a good one.
Home Alone too. Home Alone.
Ooh, Lambreth, like the really like weird
the
one.
Puppet one?
Yeah.
That was good.
I used to watch that all the time with my sister. That's such a good movie.
It was okay.
It was really good.
It was weird.
It was really weird. It was different. But it didn't make sense to me.
No sense.
I don't know if it still does make sense to me.
Also, Brave Little Toaster.
Brave Little Toaster?
Oh my god. I haven't
Brave
seen that
Brave Little Toaster. That was good.
That was I saw good. It in chat. I forgot about it. I saw it in chat.
I never
though.
Saw it.
What?
Brave Little Toaster? That's no. That's a good
What's
one.
It about?
You never had a childhood.
About Brave Toaster. Toaster.
What'd he do?
He went to Mars.
Why did he go to Mars?
Oh, he didn't go to Mars. No, what happened?
The junkyard.
The toaster was a childhood friend, or looking for his childhood friend or something like that,
yeah,
right?
Got that.
Yeah, it was something like that. Oh. I don't remember the actual story. What the hell? God, it's been so long I've seen that.
Stupid toaster.
But that's not a childhood movie for me. I mean, that was my kid's movie.
Well, that was my childhood movie, my God.
I mean, my childhood movie had to be...
Was it one of those black and white silent films?
Yeah. Yeah, pretty much.
No plot.
I'm trying to think.
Maybe the Three Stooges?
What about like...
That was my brother. My brother loved the Three Stooges. I wasn't.
What about like Mickey Mouse and stuff? Like
oh,
all
Mickey
the
Mouse.
Old,
all the Mickey Mouse. Changes. That's what... It had to be a... It was a Disney movie. I'm trying to think what earlier Disney movie, though. It had to be Bambi.
Bambi?
I mean, yeah.
But what about his mother?
Well, I didn't realize it. I didn't know any better. All I know is like, hey, look at that. They got venison. Sweet.
That's fucked up, Junk. That's horrible.
Yeah, people keep on saying good movies in the chat. Another one's Never Ending Story. That's another one of my favorites.
Yeah, that's true.
I never saw any of these movies. I guess my childhood.
Oh, my God.
Bad.
What's wrong with you?
I don't know.
I've not seen
that. That was like my
story.
Lord of the Rings back when I was a kid.
We had like we only had like a couple of movies on VHS. It was like The Sandlot, Blank Check, and then this, I think it was like Harriet the Spy. That was really it.
Oh my God.
We had like a ton of movies on VHS, like Disney movies, but I don't know. I don't like Disney movies. Pretty much the only one I really like is just Lion King. Everything else was just meh. Like, I don't know, like Little Mermaid and, you know, Cinderella and all those kind of movies never really interest me. It's just, I'm like meh.
I got to experience all that in Kingdom Hearts, so I was okay.
Wasn't Cinderella made?
Yeah.
Yeah, I think so. She clean up after her sisters or whatever.
Yeah.
Sucks to be her.
That's why
actually,
you're like,
yeah, didn't she had two older stepsisters, right?
I think so. Yeah.
I have two older sisters.
They were bullying her all the time. They're like, hey, clean up that shit, and she would have to scrub the floors and shit.
Scrub a dub dub.
My life is just like Cinderella, except for there's no prince.
Yeah, you shouldn't go to any balls, otherwise, then you're gonna lose a shoe, and then someone's gonna come after you, and it's really bad. Really, really bad.
I've never been to a ball before.
Well,
because
you should
never
go.
Wear glass shoes.
Exactly.
Yeah, every girl deserves to go to a ball.
Every girl does not deserve Rangers balls.
Yes, Man's the best movie ever.
Well, Holly, do you have anything else?
No, not that I can think of.
Well, thank you for the call, Holly.
Well, thank you for actually getting me into the call.
Don't blame me. Blame Ranger.
That was all me.
Thank you.
We enjoyed your energy that you brought into this conversation.
Yes, this is very exciting. Have a good night, Holly.
You too, guys.
Bye.
Love you guys. Bye. Bye.
Yeah.
Rager.
You know who we have to try and get in
this
here?
This guy's shady.
Brittany. Try and get Brittany back in here.
Oh, Brittany.
Yeah.
Brittany Spears. Brittany
Spears? Actually, she is from the South.
Let's see what she's on right now.
Who's Brittany?
Brittany's pretty cool.
Hi.
Ow. Hello,
some
Shady. Welcome to Chronicast.
You called me a pedo, so I got him in here. Why are you calling us pedos?
I'm early.
You need to fix your microphone. You have to lower the input.
Is that better?
No.
No.
Do you know how to work the microphone?
Better.
A little bit, yes.
I can't go down anymore without muting.
You're good. Welcome to ChronoCast.
Hi.
You have a good microphone. Don't worry. Everything's going to be okay.
No, you don't have to do the effect. You already have the effect.
Yay.
So, did you want to talk about something?
Yes.
Sure.
Alright, get rid of him.
Yeah, get rid of him.
Get rid of him.
People are just stupid.
The fuck?
Why does it take you so long to get rid of them?
Because I was going to click the wrong button, and I had to fix the button, and then it was fixed, man.
Another girl's coming in.
Is it Brittany?
No, she's not online.
Kara Knightley.
Aww.
What? If you scream into the microphone, you're going to have a bad time. So, thank you for the call.
Hey, what's going on, Nikki?
Yo, what's going on, Reach? How you doing?
You sound really quiet. You got to turn up your mic.
This is good. This is good.
I need to turn up my mic anymore.
I can't hear. Can you hear?
I hear echoes and murmurs.
I like how we go from someone who's extremely loud to someone who's extremely quiet.
This is amazing.
Hold on. I gotta yell. Sorry.
Just yell everything.
Yo, what's going on?
There you go.
Perfect.
I'm yelling. Hold on. Hello?
No, yell. Yell.
Yeah. Yo.
There you go. Hi. Right, so welcome to Chrome.
I don't want to yell. My parents are gonna be like, what?
Well, tell them about your better microphone.
Hey. Hold on. Yelling.
All right.
No.
No. Yes.
No. Stop it.
All right, so you got any questions for any of these ball masters?
Is it better? Is it better? Hello?
Yes.
Yes.
We can hear you now.
Good. Okay. So, I'm going to ask the same question like last time. Would you rather eat a 1,000-year-old cupcake or a koala?
Ew.
She'll eat yours first.
I think it's a really retarded question. I refuse to answer.
Can I ask a question, though? Okay, is the cupcake, is it, like, all moldy? Or yes. Did it just get rock
it's
solid?
It's like 1,000 years old. Of course it's moldy.
Well, no. Yeah. Did it get moldy and then rock solid? Or did it just go from being, you know, like, normal and then it just turned, like, petrified?
Yeah.
Or did it just, like, turn into mush and mold?
It's just...
Hey, plus caller would call back.
Well, which one? He said yes to both of them, so I don't know.
It's not a kind of question to be confused about.
Because if it's, like, really... If it's really hard, then you'd probably, like, break your teeth on it.
No, it's, like,
you probably
mushy.
Wouldn't really be able to eat it.
Ugh.
Oh, God.
You're
no.
thinking about this situation too much. Just pick koala
yeah, I wanted
or fucking 1,000-year cupcake.
Do I get to cook the koala?
No!
No, you have to eat it. Just grab it and eat
so
it.
So it's got to suffer?
Yes.
Do I get to, like, skin it and cut it up and just, like, cook
no,
a piece of meat?
God damn it, Jen. Do you eat the koala or the cupcake?
Koala or a cupcake?
I'll eat the koala, especially if
I'd
the cupcake's going to be moldy and mushy. No.
So you're going to take a life over a cupcake?
Yeah.
I'd eat the koala.
Australia is infantry.
Every saw its
anyway.
Poor face, like, staring at you with its eyes.
Well, it would be sad, but, I mean, I don't want
to... Yeah, you're eating it. Of course it'd be sad. It'd be angry, too. Why are you eating me? I'm so cute.
Koalas aren't cute. Apparently, they have huge claws.
But they're evil.
Yeah.
They look cute, but they're evil. And they like cocaine or something like that. I can't remember.
What? Where do you get your facts that? From? Is this yahoo.com?
No, it's, like, something... It's something in the plants they eat. It's, It makes them crazy.
Oh my god.
Let's see what it is.
What is?
You're just making up shit.
Bamboo?
I'm not making shit up.
Everything's getting made up right now.
Bamboo sticks or sugar cane?
I don't know.
What? You just confused me so much, Jan. What is wrong with you?
Alright, well, do you got any other questions that are semi-good?
Have you seen my pictures?
Yes, I have.
Oh yeah, I know you have, Rager.
Oh, wait, you're the one who's been photoshopping pictures, yeah, haven't you?
She photoshops all the
yes.
head on everything. Now she's starting with my face, so it's not good at all.
What have you? Is the question.
I retweeted, so I'm sure everyone saw it, so.
I don't watch his tweets.
You don't watch them?
I don't read them.
You
I'm, not present. I'm not present for your tweets, sir.
I'm not present for your tweets.
Are you sitting there waiting for my tweets?
Wait, wait. Have you subscribed to his Twitter yet?
Fuck no.
I stopped hearing about that a long time ago.
Oh, really? Did you?
That's why I haven't responded
Rachel,
anytime
you
say it.
My last question for you. My last
what?
Question. You should do another live stream after this. You should.
All right, I'll think about it. All right, we're going to get a new caller
goodbye,
in here, though.
Goodbye,
okay.
Goodbye,
goodbye.
Bye.
Can we get someone who's not under the influence tonight?
Bill left.
I think everybody is.
My god.
Grasping for straws
she's
just, there.
She's high on life. I can't control it.
Hello, hello.
Welcome to the call, Bill. I hope you are doing well tonight.
I'm okay, I guess.
Good. Great. I'm glad. What time is it by you, Bill?
7:30.
That's a good time. Where are you, yeah. Bill?
Canada.
That's a bad time.
You're in BC?
Yeah.
Yeah. BC's
British
nice.
Columbia.
Yeah, I know.
It's a nice place.
Yeah.
It's not very nice in the summer, though, because it gets too hot, and then there's forest fires, and that's pretty scary.
Yeah, that's kind of bad.
Forest fires, we got them all over Colorado right now.
That's why I don't want to live there.
It actually hasn't been that bad this year so far.
When I went on vacation to BC and stuff, we drove by like this mountain. The side of the mountain was all on fire. It was so scary. It was scary.
Yeah.
Hey, Bill.
Yeah.
You want to talk about something?
Yeah. Why'd you shoot first?
Oh, is this Bill?
Yep, this is me.
Wait, what's going on?
Oh,
here?
God.
What was this?
Talking about Star Wars?
No, it's in days. He encroached my position, and I got scared and nervous. I thought he was going to shoot me. And, he was like, I'm a friendly. But I'm like, I don't hear you, Bill. Say that again in English this time. He's like, I'm a friendly. I'm like, nope, not making sense to me. So I shot him, and I killed him. And, he was a friendly. And it turns out he follows me on Twitter and Facebook and YouTube, too. So,
and he's never going to let you go.
I know.
Let it go.
So, and now he's calling.
He's still a fan, too, after he did
I
that?
I guess so. Yeah. He commented on the video
dedication.
Saying, why'd you shoot me? Why'd you shoot me? It was. Bill, you would have shot me first. I know.
Was it sad then? Were you sad?
Was I sad?
Did you have a little remorse?
No. I shot him like even a couple times after he died, just to really make sure he was dead. Everything was okay.
You never know in DayZ.
I know. They come back as zombies, man. You gotta just pop two in the head, double tap. Bill, you forgive me, Bill?
Yeah, no. It was actually kind of fun.
To die in DayZ? What the fuck game are you playing? Well, thank you for.
Did you steal his stuff, Chilled?
Yeah, I took.
You
his
shot him.
Ammo.
Wow.
Yeah.
You stole your stuff, Bill. You're just gonna let him talk shit to you?
I didn't talk shit. I just shot him and stole his stuff.
You shot him and fucking took his shit.
I didn't talk shit.
Part of surviving.
Exactly.
Sir.
It was either him or the entire group was gonna die. We needed supplies, and I was able to feed the group.
All I really had though was just a bunch of family.
What game was this?
DayZ. Hey.
Oh, don't tell Junk about DayZ.
No,
he'll get
him. No. No, Junk.
No. It was DayZ.
No,
oh, my God.
DayZ.
Who thought DayZ the game was DayZ? I forgot who I was talking to, but they thought the game was just called DayZ as in the flower.
I think that was Lizzie, because I remember Lizzie saying something.
I think
like
Lizzie may have said the game. She thought that initially it was just DayZ, and she was confused why everyone wanted to play DayZ.
It's a sequel to Flower.
to Rosie.
Makes sense.
Oh, God. So, Bill, did you actually want to talk about something legitimate, or are you done for the night?
Yeah, no, that was kind of a joke. I didn't expect it to really go this far.
Damn it, Bill.
That's how I feel about all my jokes.
The jokes are stupid because they're stupid.
You know what? You're fucking British, and you have a speech impediment, and you're bad at life.
You know what? You're American, and you just make everyone in England laugh because you're American. Not because you're funny, but because you're American, and Americans are stupid.
No one in England knows who I am.
Don't be dissing America.
Hey, this has got nothing to do with you, okay?
I'm gonna whoop
it's between
you
me
my
and
muscles.
Diction.
Oh, is it between you two?
Yep.
You're insulting my country. I'm gonna have to get
you
involved.
You insult America.
Shut
you
up.
Insult everybody.
I'm have to get involved.
Everyone insults me, okay?
Well, that's
being
you live
English,
in England.
So am I just?
You're the only British guy in here. You don't want to insult us.
You know, Lizzie's not behind your back anymore.
You know, as a Canadian, I have to agree with the whole Americans are stupid.
Thank you. See,
hey,
Canadians.
Wow. Still 3-2.
Wow.
Canadians are just
we built a moose. Really? Are we going there?
It's the British and the Canadians against the Americans.
That's because you guys are just pissed off that
Canadians
you live in like French Canada,
so
not British Canada.
Yeah, it's in your Mounties down here.
You're really low addiction.
Hello? Hi.
Yeah, you're really quiet.
Hello? Can you hear me? Am I better?
If you're speaking
now?
For
yeah,
America, speak loudly.
Yeah. Don't let your country down.
Fuck Britain!
And on that note, Bill, fuck you too. I shot you for a reason, Bill. I killed a man. I know what it's like. You had to die. He's
tasted blood.
He was aiming his gun at me, all right? Regardless of what it shows on my video camera, he was aiming at me. I saw that. I saw it, all right? I panicked a little bit. I think we're good here.
Ellen!
Goddamn, Talon.
Canada is America's hat.
Yeah.
Exactly. And it's a stupid hat.
You're a beanie.
You're a stupid hat. You're... I don't know.
How can we be a hat?
Florida is America's wang.
I agree with that. And it really blows all the time. Can we get a caller in, Rager?
Oh, that's cold.
There you go. He's calling me. Alan's calling me now. What's
Damn it, name? Alan. Damn it.
You know what smells amazing?
What?
They finally have Axe for Girls, and I bought it, and it smells so good. I never wear, like, too much, like, perfume or anything like that, so.
So it's not perfume, or what the fuck is it?
It's Axe.
Body spray.
It's Axe.
Body spray, yeah.
But I can't see it smelling like girls. Or...
I don't like the Axe for guys. Like, it just smells. It's way too strong. I don't like it. I think Old Spice is so much better.
Tim Tebow. Phoenix. Hey, yo.
Hello.
Hey, welcome to the call, Tebow.
Hey. Timbo. Is that M?
Are you ready to fumble some more, Tebow? I'm just busting your chops and stuff.
So, Tebow.
I'm just busting your chops.
Wow, you know what? Your face? Shut it.
Yeah.
I don't even know who said that. Was that you, Torek? Fuck you, Torek.
That was our caller who said that.
Oh, it was
too British in here now.
Tebow, do you want to talk about something?
Wait, Tebow, where are you from?
Cumbria.
Where?
Cumbria.
Cumbria.
Northwest.
Yeah.
Where the fuck is that?
Yeah.
It's a county.
Yeah, enlighten us, you Torek. County
he
where?
Knows where it is.
We don't know counties.
Yeah, okay, that's because then you prove how smart you are. We know that you have states, yet you don't know we have counties.
Well, that's pretty stupid for counties. You should have states.
Yeah, you should have states, dude.
Yeah, what's wrong?
One of our states
What's the matter with you?
One of your states, like California, is like three Englands.
Well, it sucks to be England. You should get a bigger England. Buy more land.
Oh, what's that? We have better land mass? Yeah, it's because we rule.
Exactly. What's Manifest Destiny? Yeah, fuck you.
Remember that.
England founded America?
That's a goddamn lie.
We took it away from them.
Exactly.
What language are you speaking?
Speaking American.
Yeah, because you're fucking stupid. That's why.
Sound good. Cool stuff.
Yeah, you sound stupid.
What do you want to talk about,
okay,
Tebow?
We done.
Do you think you'll still be doing YouTube in 2 years? And if not, what will you be doing?
I was thinking maybe Subway's going to have an opening pretty soon.
God.
That's what Lizzie's doing. Isn't she?
Well, I figured I might as well learn a talent.
The one over here is hiring, I think.
I'm not going to Canada.
They're always hiring.
Yeah, Subway's always hiring.
We're at Starbucks to be a barista.
But at least. So what are you doing, Rager, in 2 years?
Wait, why are you asking me? We got a caller here.
Because what am I supposed to do?
Yeah, ask the caller this stuff.
Okay. Tim Tebow, what are you doing in 2 years?
College.
Dropping the ball. Got it. Okay, college. So, college, what do you think you're going to study in?
Multimedia.
Multimedia. It definitely works.
Yep.
Be like graphic designer or
worker. Yeah.
Oh, okay. There are jobs in that field, so you're okay.
You're okay.
Oh, there are? Oh, wow.
People,
I didn't know the way
all companies need graphic designers. You know what, Dork? You can just shut your goddamn whore mouth.
Please, can you tell me more about how there are jobs and, like, any topic of... interest, please. Just didn't know.
You tell me you can get a BA and get a job offhand.
I could.
No, you can.
Wait, a BJ and someone's gonna give you a job?
Just like a generic like business like a BA. You can't. It's so hard to get a job. But if you like specify and go into a certain course and a certain kind of like, like graphic design, you can get a job a lot easier than if you just like, oh, I'm just gonna be a BA.
Just BA?
AA,
what?
Bachelor owners.
Was that the arts and crafts one that you got, or what?
Because music is hiring, right?
Teachers are, yeah, they are.
Do you want
That's
to be
true,
a teacher,
actually.
I'd like to teach guitar.
Yeah, but I thought Todd was going to take your job.
Well, no, Todd teaches drums.
So you want to teach together. You technically want to be like the School of Rock teaching.
No. He goes to like schools and stuff. He like travels to different schools and teaches like the hired drum teacher.
So you should do that.
It's good pay. Well, I would like to do it. It's pretty easy to like teach guitar, like teach it to like primary school kids or high school kids.
How would they understand what you're saying though?
I don't understand the question.
You got the accent.
Yeah. Oh, because everyone can't understand me because everyone isn't English in England.
Yeah, but
I understand you.
I think it's just Rager being an idiot, if anything.
Mm-hmm. No.
Okay, fair enough. Rager, I'm unfollowing you on Twitter.
Oh!
But whatchamacallit, so that's, I mean...
Join the club, I'm so happy here.
I know. We'll start like a director's group of everyone not following Rager.
Oh!
Oh, God.
I'm going to go close down my account.
So what are you doing in 2 years, Rager?
I am going to be stacking boxes in a trailer.
That's good aspirations. It's good. It's good. What do you want to do in 2 years, Diction?
I'd like to be making feature films, but I'm totally okay with
this.
Sounds good. Junk, what do you want to do in 2 years?
Exactly the same thing I'm doing now. Working for the furniture company, enjoying life, enjoying good friends, doing exactly what I'm doing.
Well, tell me when you get the friends part, and I'd like to join you on that one. So, and is
hey,
Jen,
I'm here too.
I was getting to you.
You sound like you're ending it.
No, I was looking over the chat to remind myself who's in the call because someone isn't talking a lot, and that's either you or Tim Tebow.
Yeah, well, some people like to talk too much. So,
what are you doing in 2 years?
I don't get a chance. I plan on going back to school finally and doing meteorology.
Meteorology.
Ooh.
Yeah.
This question doesn't really count to Jen because she's already closed her YouTube channel.
Hate you.
And just myself, hopefully something in either marketing or YouTube or whatever it may be. So that was good. Thank you for the call, Tim Tebow.
Thank you.
And good luck in your multimedia studies, buddy.
And English. Nice.
And English, too.
English.
Yeah.
Keep up Canada.
Yeah, England.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Fuck Americans. What?
For England, James? For England.
It's a good caller. Good caller.
No.
It's not what he says. He says it's for England, James. No, for me. Dumbass.
No, at the end he does. But at the beginning it's like, yes, for
no,
England.
No, because everyone remembers.
Yeah, I watched GoldenEye 10 million times. I don't...
Everyone remembers the last quote, not the one in the middle.
Hey, Rager.
Yeah, because he's actually going to pick up.
Why don't you call? No, he says call failed.
Well, you say he wants another. He sent me a message, so.
Damn it, Rager. It says call failed.
Oh, my God. I've got. Oh, Stan Lett was a shit.
We're running out of time, man.
Oh, my God.
Jay
Mendoza.
He said he likes the Stan Lett, so.
Mendoza?
Yeah, but was he in the Stan Lett?
That's a good question. Who was the kid that jumped over the fence? What was his name?
Hello?
Jay, did you jump over a fence?
Jump over a fence?
Yeah.
No. Why?
To escape the dog.
To escape the dog? No, I'm not talking about, like, Border Patrol. I'm not talking about Border Patrol. I'm not talking about that.
You're fucking racist, dude.
Did you remember what you said last time, you asshole? And that was a serious question I had right here.
You should have heard him in his stream before this. Oh, God.
Don't you know what you're talking about?
He thought a guy from the Netherlands was, he said, are you tech support or something like that? He said.
I asked him if he was from India and if he was one of those... phone callers.
Telemarketers.
Yeah, telemarketer.
God.
Not my fault.
Jay, you ever jump a fence in the Sandlot?
I wasn't in the Sandlot.
Well, that's what we were asking.
Okay, but, yeah. I guess so. Whatever.
Wait.
Okay,
what,
then.
Really? What? I don't understand what's going on.
I don't know either. Rager added this guy on the principle that he was a Sandlot fan.
Well, you say you like
yeah,
the
Sandlot. So
I did. I acknowledged that it was that you were talking about the Sandlot.
And now we're done.
Sure.
You said
I don't understand what you're talking about, though. Like, is this an American thing? Because I don't get it.
Who is the great Bambino?
That's Babe Ruth.
There we go. Okay.
Well, thank you for the call, Jay.
That proves nothing, by the way.
What?
Did you want to talk about something, Jay?
Yeah, I had a few questions.
Okay, cool.
Shoot.
Is there any discontinued food items that you guys would want back?
Surge.
Coca-Cola vanilla.
Watermelon popsicles.
Don't they still have Coca-Cola vanilla?
Well, if they do in America, they don't have it here.
I'll send you some.
Oh, Go-Gurt.
Go-Gurt. They discontinued that?
I think so.
That was a great idea.
Did they?
Go-Gurt was amazing.
I think they still have that here.
You crafty Canadians.
We're special.
What's that energy drink that got banned that had alcohol in it?
Four Loko?
Yeah, Four Loko. That's mine.
They get banned. They just nerfed it. So now it doesn't have the caffeine.
Well, I want the original Four Loko back.
People died from that, didn't they?
Mm-hmm. Twinkies aren't discontinued, like six are they?
No.
I don't
Twinkies
think so.
Aren't banned. They still sell Twinkies.
Twinkies are on the rise.
Twinkies are on the rise.
I've never had a Twinkie.
Yeah, after Zombieland, they skyrocketed.
Honestly, Twinkies really aren't that special. you can go to a fair. Like, if you go to a fair, they deep fry them, and apparently that's really good, but by themselves, not that special.
Apparently, deep fried Mars bars are really good. They have them here.
That's a Scottish tradition. Yeah.
When they have a fair here, they always have them. I've never tried it, but I'm told it's very good.
They're really fucking good. It's like they're a heart attack in a bar.
Like, they're like $8 for one.
You could just do it yourself.
Yeah, exactly. Save so much more money.
Have you guys ever tried fried Oreos?
Yeah, no, I actually made them. I was going to do a cooking with Junkyard how to make them, because all you do, it's actually pretty easy. You just take pancake mix, and you dip it in the pancake mix and fry it in pancake mix. But they weren't that great. I mean, they were okay.
Yeah, it doesn't sound like
a Junk just poo-pooing all over this. You know?
No. It's not that. I was really looking, because I love Oreo cookies. Oreo cookies are my favorite cookie. So, with that said, you know, I wanted to, you know, I was anticipating a great cookie. But, you know, it is what it is.
You're a pretty avid deep fryer, too.
Yeah. And I love frying food. So.
I think they're amazing.
Deep fried Oreos?
Yeah.
I mean, it was the ones that I got. I actually had some of them I screwed up where I got. I ended up getting the batter in the. What do you call it? The batter didn't coat the cookie the whole way, so some of the cookie ended up being a little bit soggier compared to the other ones that were a little bit more produced. So. It was a big thing. Anyway, that's my story on an Oreo cookie.
Oh, yeah. Has anyone ever tried deep fried ice cream? I heard that's good as well, but I've never tried it.
Ooh.
I don't know how that
works.
How does that work, though? I don't understand.
It's like really hot oil, I think. I don't know.
Well, yeah, that's how you fry it.
I tried that.
Does the ice cream stay cold, though? Like, obviously, it wouldn't. Wouldn't the ice cream just melt?
No, it stays cold.
How?
It's just like a layer of batter, and then it's cold in the middle.
Ew. I don't know how I feel about that.
I wish I had pancake mix.
I have a video how to make pancake mix.
Well, I wish I had some right now.
I want Belgian waffles.
I would make some pancakes.
Oh.
And they would be dandy junk.
Oh, they're so good. They're the best thing ever. They're so fluffy.
Well, do you have anything else you want to talk about, Jay?
I have a question about the PVRs. Do they record everything, or is it just like Xbox 360 and PS3?
Well, you can do anything that has component inputs. So if you have a cable box, or for some reason you have a TV that you have to record, like, I don't know, just if it has like a component out, if you plug in like a video camera to it, but you just plug in a video camera anyway. Anything that has component output, you could plug in.
Okay. Well, that's pretty much all I had to ask.
Well, thank you for the call, Jay.
Oh, you're welcome.
Well, goodbye, Jay.
Alrighty.
Bye.
Alrighty then.
See you later, dude.
Later.
That was
all right. Weird. Is that the last one?
Well, we can get one more caller for the night.
All right. I gotta find a good one.
Please do. Make it something where, as if they bring excitement and action to a whole new level.
Well, how can I tell who's gonna do that?
I kind of want another question about my parents neglecting me when I was a child.
I would like more child neglect questions, please. And let's bring up racism and religion as well. And hopefully some other controversial shit.
Dude, I love racism religions.
I love West Baptist Church.
Right, this is perfect right here. This is perfect.
Jack Daniels. Goddamn.
Your musical talents are subpar.
Spare me of your musical shit.
Spare me of my ears bleeding.
Oh my god.
Jack? I don't know when you joined. Jack. I just keep saying Jack. Jack?
Jack!
Jack! Oh, that doesn't sound right.
Back up ready to go.
Jackie boy!
Jackin'!
Jacktastic!
Press X to jack it.
Take off your pants and jacket.
Jack!
Alright, let's get Charles Rose in here.
Jack!
We'll kick Jack. There we go.
Charles,
this is our only hope.
Charles, you're the last call. You're going to be amazing, Charles.
I am. Chill to talk to you 2 weeks ago. Of course.
What did
I
we
am.
Talk about?
I said thank you for doing all the videos.
Oh. Well, thank you for saying thank you.
Yep.
Thank you.
I know where you're going with this.
Okay, so Charles, how you doing?
We got for us. Come on, it's got to be a zing banger, biggity boo, or whatever you call that.
Yep, just.
Huh?
When are you guys getting all together for a like big old stream?
This is it.
What I mean, like?
What
is it? A video. A game.
Actually playing something.
Yeah.
That's a good question.
This is a good question.
Tomorrow? Do it tomorrow.
I'm off tomorrow. That works for
tomorrow.
Me.
So tomorrow, Charles.
I just threw that out there.
I work tomorrow.
You work tomorrow? We'll quit work.
I got like 10 points. And 12 points to get fired.
Do you have a point-based system?
Yeah, every time you call in, it's 1 point.
Does it reset?
Yeah, after a year, you call in.
So how long until it resets?
It's like a year basis. Well, it just depends on when you get your points.
Well, for
it's
you.
It's like a year after
for
you get your point.
Without you.
That's going to be a while.
I told you should have called off for Mass Effect.
Maybe I just like started last week. I already got 10 points.
Maybe another year.
Oh, man. Because literally, I think you did too many of those videos where you were just like, I'm taking off from work today to play this game. I've seen at least 4 this year of you doing that, so I can only imagine.
Yeah, that was 4 points.
Man, they're gonna take away your license in no time with all these points.
Fuck the police.
I got another question for you guys.
Yes, Charles.
I don't know how many of you are based on West Coast of America or in that general location, but is there like an event some of you guys would be going to that I like meet up with you guys, say hello?
I'm going to San Diego in like 2 weeks.
Are you still going to that?
I'm going to the Walking Dead Escape thing. I'm going to be next to Comic-Con. And apparently there's some big tomato fight I'm going to, too.
Oh, my God. Is that like the Hey Arnold thing?
There's going to be like a massive tomato battle or something.
That was in Hey Arnold, right? It was like called the Tomato War or something? They had like an episode?
I have no idea. I just heard about it today, so I don't know the info about it.
Are you
going to
throw tomatoes at people?
Yeah, there's going to be some people going down with tomatoes.
Pretty cool.
I'm going to throw like a point-blank range at him right in the face.
Tomato.
Will you be there, Diction?
I'm going to PAX Prime up in Seattle. That's where I'm going.
When's that?
August 31st. It's all sold out, though.
Fuck. Yeah. Is there, like, outside of the event, like, fan meetup?
Ooh.
I mean, I know I'm going to get crab at this one place, so I want to show up.
No, he's not talking about crab. He's not talking about a brothel.
Dinner in a movie.
Wow. Dinner in a movie and crabs.
Oh, he's got crabs.
So he's going to get crab at one place, Charles.
It's just like Giggles, where you go in and you get crabs just for walking in the doorway.
That's not good. Oh, jeez. Sounds like my kind of place, but that's not good.
I need a crab handout.
It's American.
What kind of crab place? Is this like a specialty crab place or just like, you know, Joe's Crabs type thing?
Does Joe have crabs?
I don't know, but I always loved those t-shirts that said, I got my crabs from Joe. I love those kind of t-shirts.
Especially when females wore it. And when guys wore it, it was even better.
So many Joes out there.
Oh, Joes never know what giving you want. Shit around.
One of them has crap.
The gift that keeps on giving. So, Charles, do you have anything else before we wrap up the show tonight?
I think I'm good, but, you know, it's been a joy talking with you guys.
It's been a joy as well, Charles.
Pleasure. I mean, well, we're trying to figure some things out. Like, I'm supposed to be going to New York in October if everything works out.
Don't find me, Junk. Don't even come close to me.
And I was trying to get in touch with Chilled, but he said he may have school that
I'm going to have midterms, but if you want to come the week earlier, we can go to Comic-Con.
I can't go the week earlier. Well, then,
Junk, you're SOL.
I might be out in New York. No one goes to that Comic-Con.
Oh, God. Wait, Comic-Con?
No, they're having a TV film festival we submitted the Friend Zone to, so we're thinking of going out there.
When is this, approximately?
I'm not entirely sure. I just know October.
October, maybe?
I can find out, though.
It's the week of the Comic-Con. My God.
Oh!
I want to go there. I just want to, like, find Diction, just stare at him from across the hall, and hopefully he doesn't recognize me, and just, like, follow him around. Eventually he would get suspicious, but I'm hoping to do that.
You have a pretty unique face, so I'm going to go ahead and say no.
I'll cosplay.
Where were those glasses with mustaches?
You got to get a fake mustache.
Right? I think I make
it.
Just
a
fake mustache.
The Dick something. Dick Clark. Or that, no, Dick Cheney? No, whatever it is. Dick something.
Spy glasses.
If you wear the Dick Cheney mask, you'd be very
good. I need a shotgun if I'm going to wear the Dick Cheney mask. That's not going to work out too well. But yeah, no, I'm going to find you, Dick.
You're in America. We're in America. We got shotguns everywhere.
That's true. I went upstate, and I didn't know if I was hearing fireworks or gunshots. It was weird.
That was like a scatter.
That's what was good.
It was weird because it was just like, it was like five things, like bang, and bang, 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 bang. And I'm like, that's weird. I didn't hear any screams.
Okay, I got shot at last week. It was interesting.
Did you really?
Yeah, I was out camping, and we were walking in the dark, and we heard a crack, and I saw the bullet go right over my head.
These deer sure look like human. We better shoot them.
I dropped to the ground and drew my 1911. It was not fun. We had a yelling match between me and the other guy.
Would he think you were, like, deer or something? These deer are packing?
I have no idea.
That's weird.
I don't know, because I pulled my 1911. I was like, if you fire again, I will shoot back.
Well,
that's cool. I want a gun.
The man just got in a shootout. You're like, I want one of those.
Now in Europe, you can't have guns there, right?
We can only have hunting rifles and shotguns. There's no pistols allowed or automatic
rifles. I kind of think that's a good idea. No handguns. It's just,
how much did your 1911 cost you?
It's a Springfield. I got mine for like $600, and then
are they cheaper,
I went.
Though?
Mine was secondhand.
Okay.
So it wasn't a brand new one, but it's a full sized. And I even
how
got,
much was it?
It was like 600.
That's like 400, 500 pounds. That's really cheap for like a weapon.
I've been wanting to go. You know that? Have you seen that show on American Guns on Discovery Channel?
Yeah.
Is that the one where it's the people come in and get custom guns?
Yeah, Gunsmoke. You know that?
Is it Gunsmoke? That's not the one.
Yeah, there's two of them. There's the one where it's in where they build those massive. Impressive guns down in Louisiana. I think that's Guns and Son of Guns or something like that.
Son of Guns, that's the show.
Yeah, I'm talking about American Guns. It's about Gunsmoke, and it's about a dad and his two kids run the shop.
Mm-hmm.
That's Gunsmoke, and it's here in Colorado. And actually, I know exactly where it is. I've never been in there. But I've been meaning to go over there just to see what they got. But they just built a new shooting range right down the street here. Right on my way to work, you could actually see it. So it's actually pretty cool. I've been meaning to stop there. Because they say it's like $20 to shoot for an hour, I guess it is.
Stuff, Jack.
That's really cheap.
So
you have to pay for ammo, too, because that's really
well,
cheap.
You can bring your own. You can bring, if you bring all your own stuff, then you could. They just charge you $20 for the range.
Oh, that's nice. The places I go shoot at, they want non-lead bullets, so you have to buy their rounds.
Non-lead bullets?
Oh, really? Yeah. I don't know what
bullets?
The whole...
Yeah, well, they're copper. Okay. It's copper-shelled. So the lead, they don't want people getting poisoned when they have to go sweep up downrange.
Okay. Copper bullets. You know, back in World War II, pennies... weren't turned, they weren't copper.
We had to use copper for bullets, so we had steel pennies.
Yeah.
That was. I have a couple of steel pennies. They're cool. It's weird seeing like a silvery-looking penny.
Oh yeah, I've seen a couple of those.
Yeah, because we needed it for that. We needed it for the war. I don't know why we just didn't shoot steel at people. That should have worked.
Well, the copper jacket was it wasn't armor piercing.
Oh.
See, the armor piercing would go straight through you and not do that much damage, but the copper would allow it to mushroom, and so it would have Ooh. More surface area to hit you with.
Well, those were all also hollow points, aren't they?
Well, yeah, but they didn't have hollow points in World War II, and all the weapons were high caliber, like .30-06, and so you already have a round that's flying at a couple thousand feet per second, and so if you put a steel core on that, that's going to send it straight through somebody.
Oh, I did not know that.
Let's go shoot.
Yeah, I want to go shoot some steel bullets.
I haven't shot in a really long time. I'd like to go back.
I know, I haven't either. You know, I just bought a shotgun from my friend.
Didn't you have a Saiga addiction? I saw it from one of your first videos. Did you get that one from the range?
No, that was my friend Ben's Saiga.
I've been wanting to get one of those.
They're pretty awesome.
At the Cabela's here in up in Vancouver. You can get the 20-round drum mag for it.
Ooh. Yeah, I live in California, so they neuter all the guns so that they're all semi-auto and pussified and not fun. I mean, they're still fun to shoot, but they're not as fun as they could be.
But I don't come want up to work, guy with like a
can have automatics
here. Drum and bazookas and all that.
I'd love to.
It just takes one crazy guy, Dixon.
It really does.
It just takes one crazy guy to give him like a full auto bazooka type thingy with the drum round and stuff, and then boom.
Yeah. But, I mean...
Yeah, I mean, so what's your point?
Yeah, it's like, if that guy was smart enough to not get, like, convicted of any crimes or put in a mental institution before he made the decision to go crazy, then, you know, it's not on the state or whoever or whoever sells him the gun.
Yeah, but, you know, if he doesn't have, like, the full automatic Tommy gun drum rounds, I'd feel a lot more comfortable if he had to manually shoot one at a time.
What did that guy in Oslo have, though? He had bombs. He made bombs, dude. You didn't even need a gun. He made bombs.
That is true. Like, but weren't those unsuccessful? It was more of the shooting rampage he went on. I don't think he actually killed anyone with the bombs.
Right? Yeah. Well, he could have, though.
He actually did you see that? He demanded to be let free because he was fighting for some of his own psychology, some stupid freedom that he was talking
about.
He's
out of his mind. He is he's totally out of his mind. Insane.
He's a little nuts.
He started crying in court when they read his manifesto.
Oh, really?
He is out of his mind.
This is
beautiful. Yes,
I'm so glad
mind.
I wrote this. Crazy.
Crazy.
Crazy bad
Crazy
person.
Crazy for you. What? Well, I think that's about it for tonight, Charles.
All right, that's it.
Yeah.
Alrighty.
I love you, Charles.
This is good talking to you.
Thank you for the gun.
Yeah.
The gun tech and information.
Yeah, that was a good last call. Definitely.
Yeah, that's good.
Man, learned. Never shoot steel. It'll go through a person.
I learned.
I think it'd be fun to, like, shoot a sniper, you know, and always try and get it, like, on...
So actually kill a sniper?
On the target? No, like, be the person who is a sniper, and you're trying to, you know, like, shoot a target and always get it, like...
Well, you like to shoot a sniper rifle.
Yeah. I think that'd be fun. Because, you know, you have to try and, like, go against the wind and that kind of thing and try and get on the dot.
Well, that's really just for long range. I mean, if you want to start out, pick up a little $100 .22 rifle. Get a nice 2 or 3X scope on it. And you start plinking rounds until you can put two in the same hole at 100 feet. And be good to go.
Yeah, I'm just going to shoot my BB gun in the backyard, and that sounds about right.
I'm not gonna buy a gun, no. But I'm just saying it'd be cool.
Well, Charles, thank you again for the lesson, and have yourself a good night, man.
You too. Take care. You guys have a good night.
Well, that guy was cool.
Yeah. There you go.
That guy was cool. Does anyone have anything to say for the end of the night?
You know, I'm just enjoying the company. Want to talk, I guess, a little bit more about something later on.
Are we talking like a little something?
I got nothing. Oh,
good.
Is that something sexual?
Hopefully not.
Oh, there's Utoric.
I've been here this entire time, just listening to what he was saying.
Oh.
Yeah.
Wow. Well,
but it is like 10 past 4 in the morning.
Right now.
Yeah, it's 10 past 4.
Mike. Who's Mike?
Yeah, I was just gonna ask, who's Mike?
Is anyone Mike here?
Mike. Oxlong.
No.
There's
Mike.
No one Mike, but thank you anyway. Good night, sir.
There is no Mike here. Please leave.
You meant Nick? Did he say Nick?
Maybe.
Nick, you're now Mike.
Damn
it. Close enough. Well, I guess on behalf of Chronicast, and anyone else want to say goodnight? Because I'm saying goodnight.
Goodnight.
Farewell. Yeah, be the same.
You guys have yourself a good night.
Yeah.
Woo.
Stuff.
I love you, Torek.
Go away.
Rage, I'm unfollowing you.
You forgot to tell people to follow the stream.
I forgot to tell people to follow the stream.
Yep.
It's always next week.
Sure.